What's up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of our show For the Love of the Game. Ako po si Ken Pangilinan, kasama si Dino Lee, and ang nag-iisang the one-arm bamba, Miss Kat Tan. Kita nyo naman, excited na excited yung mga kasama ko. And ako rin, sobrang excited dahil love month nga ngayon. It's February, our first episode of the month, and dahil love month, kaming tatlo, it's no secret na ang love talaga namin. First love namin is basketball. So ayan, for you guys, gift namin ito sa inyo. Itong lahat ng episodes for this month, puro basketball players ang ating guest. So ayan, episode 28, entitled Whatever It Takes. So gusto ko lang batiin yung ating viewers who are watching us on Facebook and on YouTube. So maraming salamat, especially yung mga lagi nanonood sa atin since day one. Yan, sila Arsenic Salangsang, John Maverick Cheng, si Vance Clarin who recently watched. Pero ito, nanonood ngayon. So yun, maraming salamat sa inyo, guys. And ito lang, titake ko lang yung opportunity for us to acknowledge our previous guest. So yun nga, si Pauline Lopez and Jamie Lim, currently sa Inspire Academy, preparing for a possible qualifying spot sa Olympics, no? So very uncertain pa yan, but grabe, pukpukan yung training nila dyan. So wishing them luck if they're watching. And ito, si EJ Obiena. Ito lang, recently, this 2021, pinaunlakan tayo ng bagong record, Philippine record, sa indoor pole vault. So, nagtala siya ng 5.62 meters, na-clear niya yun. Good for fifth place doon sa tournament nila sa Germany. So, yun. And of course, yung special guest natin, yung coach niya, nasa sariling bubble din for Gilas Pilipinas, no? They're currently training for the FIFA Asia Cup, yung qualifying tournament para sa World Cup, no? So, pukpukan din yan this month. Yun na nga, recent headline, si Kai Soto just arrived from the US. Ayun, grabe. So, ito na nga. Kumbaga, matindi yung mga kalaban nila. Korea, Indonesia, Thailand. So, ayan, abangan nyo yan. And, ayun. So, siguro, guys.
If you guys are excited for the love month, for those who are watching right now, please do like and share this episode on your page. And to those who haven't subscribed or followed us, we are on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube. It's at For the Love of the Game PH. And we are also on Twitter. It's at FTLOTGPH. And again, guys, we are now on Spotify, Apple Podcast, and Anchor. There you go. So we are still currently uploading the past episodes. So we are still in the process of it. But yeah, there are a lot of things to look out to in the future for the love of the game. So yeah, there you go.
Ayan, this is our episode for tonight. Yan nga, basketball. For sure, ang daming basketball fans na nanonood ngayon. Please, share nyo naman, what are you excited about this episode? So, ayun, paramdam nyo naman sa guest natin kung anong excited kayo na malaman tungkol sa kanya. Of course, for sure, marami tayong matututunan. So, libre po ang comment section para dyan. So, yun nga, if you have questions, suggestions, shoutouts, ayan, itype nyo lang sa comment section. So, yun, ako, really excited. Ikaw, Dino, for sure. Excited na excited ka, di ba?
Hindi. In-heartbreak niya ako nung college days.
Ganun ba?
Puro heartbreaks ang binigay ni... Puro sakit ng ulo, puro heartbreaks ang binigay nito sa atin ng guest natin. Pero all is forgiven, di ba? Siyempre, we move forward in life, di ba? Sa pag-ibig, nakakapag-move on tayo. Nakakapag-move on din tayo sa basketball. Di ba, Kat?
No? Hugot ka naman eh.
Oo. Maaga pa para sa mga hugot natin. Pero since it's the love month, pagbibigyan kita dyan.
Correct. Yan. Siyempre, especially for next week's episode, yun na yung Valentine's Week. No? But on a serious note, especially for our first-time viewers, if there are people here that's watching us for the very first time, you know, we just want to share what our podcast is all about. And when we want to describe it through a phrase, we always tell people that it's inspiring possibilities from real-life sports stories. Kasi we bring in, you know, not just anyone from the sports community, but we actually bring in the cream of the crop. The ones that have achieved so many things despite all the odds stacked against them. And we want their stories, no, their real life stories to inspire possibilities for you guys and for the people that's gonna watch us in the future. And yun nga, mahanap nyo kami on Spotify na rin. If hindi kayo ma-video, pwede nyo pakinggan through Spotify. You can just type in FTLOTG on Spotify. You can already find the first six episodes namin uploaded there. So yun, it's really about inspiring possibilities. And I'm sure, I'm pretty much excited because yung guest natin for tonight, na-inspire ako last week, Ateneo yung guest ngayon tonight, Ateneo din yung guest natin, and I'm sure I'm gonna be inspired and it's gonna allow me to learn as well as a host. No? Hindi lang kayo, pero ako personally, natuto din ako from our guest. But before we bring our guest for tonight in, of course, we have certain rules of engagement here on our show. Yun, kayo mga viewers, if you... Siyempre, pag nag-drive kayo, hindi nyo magagawa to. But if you guys are... we appreciate for you for tuning in kahit nag-drive kayo. But if you guys are at home, you can actually type and talk with us, comment. We invite you, of course, number one, to appreciate our guests because yung guests natin, very busy yan. Apart from being involved in sports, sa particular league niya, he also has a lot of businesses. And our only request is for you to, you know, appreciate this person tonight kasi magbibigay ng oras to share so many things for all of us. And of course, number two, kung na-appreciate niyo na siya, mag-share din kayo ng learnings because that can be another topic. That can be another topic that we can talk about during the show and maybe, you know, makapag-share din ng thoughts, not just us, but also yung guest natin for tonight. And last but not the least is, of course, you are free, no? Dahil sa sobrang busy, ito na yung opportunity nyo to ask questions sa guest natin for tonight. And yun nga, ang request namin yung tatlo is for you to guys to engage with us, go down the comment section, appreciate our guest, share your learnings, and ask questions because, you know, hindi lang itong show para lang sa host and para lang sa guest natin, but it's actually for all of us, no? As one community here sa Philippine sports. And of course, Ken, I think I'm good, yeah.
Oo, ako, yun nga, share ko lang but excited ako. Yun nga, binanggit ko offline, no? Kasi, yun na nga, nakasabay ko to nung high school. Ito, makwento ko lang briefly. Grabe, pinaggagawa nito nung intrams. Kasi, yung, alam nyo na may corner three-pointer, di ba? Kasi, dikit-dikit yung courts namin dun, eh. So, yung corner three-pointer, manipis lang yun. Kumbaga, malapit na sa outside. Eh, syempre, pag in-drums, yung special guest natin, kumbaga, double team, triple team. Pero grabe, pag pasak, kahit pa-outside na, pupukol ng tres, pasok talaga eh. Nakakabilib, no? Pero yun, like Dino mentioned offline, kahit ganun yung height niya, ganun yung physique niya, kumbaga, dami niyang nalagpasan na obstacles sa kanyang basketball career. And I'm sure, yan, maraming may inspire ngayong gabi sa kanyang kwento.
Ikaw naman, maraming makaka-relate kasi ang journey niya, I think, is a David Goliath eh. So maraming for sure makaka-relate na mga ballers out there, yung maliliit, no, na maninipis. Yun, isa yan. Ikaw ba, Kat?
Ako, excited ako. Well, sabi mo nga, Dino, isa yan sa mga since diehard ano rin ako. Eh. Siyempre, I'm a true Lasallian, you know? I'm a true Lasallian. So, isa yan sa mga pumupukol dati sa Ateneo na pag, alam mo na, pag tumira, pasok na eh, di ba? But yeah, I'm really just so excited to be talking about basketball and to be learning a lot. I'm sure ako, yun nga, sabi nga natin offline, I'm really excited the way he has conquered his journey dito. So yeah, I'm just excited to talk to him and share his experience with us.
Yeah. Yan. Perfect. Ayun. Yan, siya rin yung rason, Ken, before you introduce him. Siya rin yung rason kaya hindi ko na tinatapos yung game, pinapatay ko na yung TV kasi masyadong masakit panoorin.
Mas masakit yung sa akin, Dino, kasi pinapanood ko to ng live eh.
Okay.
Nakikita ko siya live eh.
Buti so, na lang yung, hindi na ako nag-live.
yung crowd, yung, alam mo yun, yung iba talaga yung ano. Pero gusto ko lang din malaman, Dino, kasi you mentioned also in one of my posts eh. Kung sino ba sa amin ma-shooter sa tingin mo? lamang lang siya ng sinong ma-shooter. Lamang siya ng konti.
Di natin alam.
No, I'm
pretty sure ito talaga on point yan. On point shooter.
Yun.
So, yeah. Ayun. So guys, wag na nating patagalin pa. Let's introduce our special guest for tonight. So yun, he's the head of basketball operations ng Nueva Ecija Rice Vanguards in the MPBL. And speaking of MPBL, he was voted as the North All-Star starter nitong recent All-Star game and part of the All-MPBL second team back when he was playing for the Navotas Clutch noong 2019. And ito naging MVP candidate din as an Asian import sa ASEAN Basketball League. Naging player nga siya ng Bangkok Cobras and Saigon Heat. He's a rookie of the year sa UAAP back in 2005 and a two-time champion back-to-back sa seniors division ng UAAP noong 2008 and 2009. So before we bring him in, please watch this trailer.
Tignan natin itong galaw ni Jai Reyes.
Please welcome our special guest for tonight, the one and only, the Dynamite, Jai Reyes!
Andiyan mo siya? Jai?
Andiyan mo.
There you go. Sorry.
Kano ko naman.
Ganda ng intro ninyo. Talaga, ano, very, very professional talagang pinagandaan.
Yeah, syempre. Ayaw namin mapaya yung guest namin, di ba? At saka syempre dapat ma-proud sila sa pag, ano, syempre we do our best. So, thank you for appreciating what we do, Jai. Kamusta naman? Welcome to our show.
Oh, salamat na gines niyo ako. Grabe, bigatin yung mga previous guests ninyo. So, sana hindi maka-disappoint yung episode na to. And I'm excited for tonight.
Yeah. Of course, syempre ganda ng shirt, no? Pilipinas plus Ateneo, 'di ba? So masakit makita, masakit para sa amin ni Kat, pero okay naman, all is forgiven. But of course, we want to shout out certain people na nag-comment na, no? Hindi pa pumapasok yung guest natin for tonight, but they're actually excited to watch our episode. Of course, ito Jai, teammate namin 'to sa ano, she's a big fan of yours kasi sabi niya kamukha mo daw yung kapatid niya. So parang kahit na sala-sala siya, fan daw sila nung naglalaro ka pa sa Ateneo. Ayun. Baka gusto mong i-shoutout, Jai.
Hi, Kathleen Sitinko. I hope I pronounce your name right. Thank you very much and sana mag-enjoy kayo.
Yeah. And of course, a high school student who's been tuning in with us since episode 4, no, Ken? Tama ba? Si John. Yeah, episode 4. He's also into basketball. So what's up, FTLOTG fam? Hope you guys are having a wonderful Wednesday evening. So yan, ito yung parang stress reliever daw niya sa school. Every Wednesday, nag-tune in siya. Thank you, John Maverick Cheng. And of course, ito yung solid supporter namin since episode 2. He's also a high school student from Binondo, wants to play college basketball and pro basketball eventually. So, hello Arsenic. Jai, baka you wanna shout out one of our solid supporters here, si Arsenic.
Hello Arsenic, ganda ng ano mo, ng profile picture, Kobe. Ano, I was fortunate enough na ano, naging coach ko yung dad niya nung nasa ABL ako.
Tama. And thus, the nickname, Bangkok Mamba. Tama, di ba?
Yes.
Around that same time kasi nabali rin yung ilong ko, bali rin yung ilong ni Kobe. I think nakamask siya. So,
tama.
Ni Coach Jellybean sa akin. So,
tama. Ayan, of course, may mga fans, di ba? Nahiya naman ako kay Kat, may mga fans din dito. Di ba? Bukod sa guest natin.
Bakit
for tonight. Love you, Kat. Love month naman.
Aha. Diba? And then kabarkada ko yan. I just want to congratulate him bagong kasal yan eh. So yeah, congrats.
Ah, wow. Jolo. Congratulations, Jolo. Yan.
One of my ano. Yan nakakalaro ko yan lagi. Basketball yan ang tropa namin dito sa village, and ako lang yung only girl na naglalaro sa amin sa barkada namin. Tapos lahat sila, guys, shooter din yan. So, congrats, Jolo, pala. Again.
Yeah, yan. And of course, ito na nga yung binabanggit ko. Hello po sa ating guest na sobrang hawig ng brother ko, diba? Patingin daw ng picture. Si Jai daw ang magja-judge, diba? And of course, a fellow Atenian, no? Kaklase ni Ken. Kaklase nila to
nito. Kasi namin Tonino. Yan.
Ni Tonino. Okay, yan. Supporting our show since episode, I think, 4 pa to eh. Tagal na nito nanonood. So, Carl, the dentist, no? Hello. Yan.
Oh. Kumbaga kung paano binuhat ni Jay yung mga team niya sa high school. Ganun din tayo binuhat ni Tonino, no? Carl.
May nagulat. Nagulat nga ako kin eh. Parang pwede pala sila maglaro sa, sa intrams eh. Grabe mag-do. Siyempre, condition din. Naawa tuloy ako dun sa mga kalaban. Anyway. Eh, nasabi ko nga kanina, yung batak na si Sir Jai. Yan,
sabi. Late na.
Late na. Tapos, ayan, one of our, who's been supporting us since, episode 4 din to. He's been tuning in. So, hello Jai, namuntik ko matawag na kay... Ah, okay, sorry. Admittingly, isa talaga sa powerhouse ng MPBL ang Nueva, Ecija. Kaya sobrang bilib sa pamumuno mo. Congrats po. Jai, any thoughts around that?
Thank you. Sobrang excited na talaga kami makapaglaro ulit eh. Yung buong MPBL family, hindi lang yung Nueva, Ecija, kundi lahat ng team. So, sana manood pa rin kayo dahil yun, marami kaming surprise for this coming season.
Meron na bang, Jai, meron na bang estimated timeline kung kailan babalik yung MPBL?
Wala pa kasi of course kailangan muna magkaroon ng approval from the government, and that's what the MPBL is working on right now.
Ayan. yan. So kailangan may approval pa. Okay, perfect.
Yes.
Eto.
Dami nagko-comment.
Dami, teka. Yeah, baka di tayo, baka alas 12 na tayo. Nag-aalaga pa ng bata si Jai.
Oo nga eh.
Oo nga.
Uy, may nag-comment na page, no? Si PBA Memes. Eto si Jai Reyes, legit na deserving sa respect. Basta fan ka ng Philippine basketball kahit anong team o liga. Kung lumaki lang ng konti, dami piniyak nito. Sorry, PBA, di ba? Respect.
Wish ko talaga yan, kahit mga 3 inches pa. Sana lumaki ako.
Yeah, actually, Jai, may nag-comment nga when we shared your post in one group. Kung hahaba sana yung career mo sa PBA talaga if you just had parang 3 inches, yun yung kinoment eh. So, yun. Eto, Lauren De Los Santos, Jainamite fan here since 2, grabe naman to, 11 years.
Tagal na yan, college days pa.
Ayan, of course, familiar ka ba kay Lauren, Jai?
Well, hindi. Pero, hi Lauren. Thank you for the support since Ateneo Day.
Grabe, no? Swertehin ka, may 11 years ka na fan, di ba? Since 2009. And of course, Carlo Balmaseda. Mukhang
familiar ka.
Dynamite. Teammate namin yan. Teammate namin yan in Ateneo, both in high school and college. Kamusta na, Carlo?
Sa si Jags yata nanonood yan sa high school. Grabe.
Yeah. And of course, di ba?
Yun, ayun na.
Yan, Zags.
Batak na yan, Boss Jai.
Tino mo nga yung, look at the arms of Zags sa profile picture niya.
Grabe nga eh. Tsaka pumayat eh. Parang I think nag-slim down siya pero nag-tone yung muscle talaga as compared to before.
Nag-hire ng nutritionist.
Yan. And if you guys don't notice, may nag-comment na tayong around 180 plus viewers. Actually, we're down to 150 right now. So, grabe yung support. So,
umabot ng
200 eh. So, thank you guys for tuning in. I hope magbibigyan natin ng justice yung episode na to for you guys to stay up until the end. So, we truly appreciate all of you. And of course, ito, syempre kilala ko tong player, idol Kuya Jai. Ayan, baka gusto mong batiin din, Jai. Magaling na player to, second year high school.
Paano ba i-pronounce pangalan niya? Clives?
Clives.
Yan. Ay, sana ano, ma-meet ko kayo one day, makapaglaro tayo dyan.
Yon, ayos. Tapos yan, ito, last comment before, ano, excited na sa MPBL, at least dito patas ang laban. Okay. Hindi ko nabasa eh, kaya pinlash ko na lang. Baka gusto mo, you want to add anything? Ako.
Ano lang tayo, ang gusto ko lang sa Pilipinas is maraming fans ng basketball talaga. So sana lahat ng league supportahan natin. Kanya-kanya naman 'yan eh ng preference. So ang importante, merong mga naglalarong mga liga para sa lahat.
Nagulat ako sa comments, sorry. Nagulat ako. Ayan, but 'yun. Thank you Jai. And I think yan, ito last to. Jai, who's MPBL's new broadcast partner, if you have any idea na?
Julian, good question. Right now, wala pang nire-release about the broadcast partner. Pero I'm pretty sure for the coming seasons, meron efforts to make the game easier to access for all the fans. Na tipong on-demand, anytime pwedeng panoorin. So that's what all of us want for the MPBL dahil live audience, grabe talaga yung pumupuntang fans sa games ng MPBL. So I think the next step is yun, gawa ng mas magandang platform ni MPBL for viewers to watch.
Right.
Ayun. So guys, yun na nga, since nanonood kayo ngayon, in-invite ko kayo to please like and share this episode on your Facebook pages. And eto na nga, sisimulan na natin himayin ang journey na nag-iisang the Dynamite, Jai Reyes. So yun, Jai, simulan na natin, no? Kasi syempre, basketball pinag-uusapan. Matanong na nga rin ka namin, yun nga, basketball ba yung first choice mo? And what made you pursue basketball seriously?
As far as I can remember, nandiyan na talaga yung basketball dahil sa pamilya namin eh. More on sa Reyes side talaga, sa side ng dad ko. So lima silang lalaki, panganay si Tito Chot, then my dad, Mike, June, then Billy. So almost all of them involved in basketball in some way until now. So pati yung mga pinsa nila, Mark Molina, so it just runs in our blood. So kasama sa mga first memories ko, basketball talaga.
Yeah. Just to add, Jai, no, you mentioned Billy Reyes, no, he was actually during my first year sa varsity sa high school, he was actually my coach, si Coach Billy Reyes. I don't know if maalala pa niya ako, pero ako'y lagi pinapagalitan. Naalala ko kasi, Jai, nagpa-practice kami, nagtuturo siya ng play, nagbabasa ako ng diary.
Ayos.
Tapos ang sabi niya sa akin, anong balita? Sabi ko, anong coach? So, sorry coach, pero miss na kita. Naalala ko yun eh. Nakakaya yun.
Yun nga Jai. So nag-start ka ba mag varsity grade school SBP? Nagsimula ka na ba doon?
SBP yung first formal team ko, yung organized team talaga. Pero before that, yung mga inter-village ganun, talagang parati kami naglalaro park games. Yan yung pinakamasayang form of basketball for me as far as I can remember nung bata ako. So yeah, I started 9 years old. That was my first team SBP. So that is how I started my journey in Ateneo for playing for the school. So grabe, with you asking that question, ang daming memories na sila LA Tenorio, Don Bosco pa siya noon, sila Chris Chu and si Charles sa Xavier. So nostalgic for you to ask that question.
So umbaga nung mga bata pa kayo, talagang nagkakalaban na kayo ever since?
Oh yes, maraming players. Of course, marami rin yung nag-iba na ng career. Pero yeah, sila LA, sila Chris, buti nilang they ended up in Ateneo rin somehow. So yeah, nagkakalaban talaga kami simula bata. Tapos si Simon Atkins, even before siya naglasal, magkalaro na kami sa mga court ng Merville. So yun, it's beyond the UAAP and the school experience. I think that's what represents basketball for me.
So how was it for you na yung mga dati mong kalaban naging teammate mo? So anong mo doon, approach mo doon na uy, kalaban lang kita, biglang kakampi mo na eh, no? So how was that for you?
Masaya dahil yung mga players na yun, di mo na po problemahin eh, as kalaban. Magkakatulungan na kayo, di ba? So, yun yung pinaka-experience ko doon. Buti nilang maganda yung recruitment program rin ng Ateneo. That's why we were able to build a very good team. And until now, yun pa rin yung, nandyan pa rin yung foundation na yun. And, you know, sana tuloy-tuloy yung success ng program.
Yeah. Nakairos ako tuloy, Jai. Meron ka bang natuwa ka talaga, ay, so, buti na lang naging teammate ko.
Meron bang particular?
Meron ba ganun?
Si LA talaga. Dahil siya yung player, sila ni Chris Chu, yung mga player na ever since SBP days, dominant na sila eh. So, alam mo talagang magiging magaling. So, yun, tuwang-tuwa naging kakampi ko yung dalawa, lalo na si LA. Rookie ako noon, tapos fifth year niya. So everyday, nagkakabantayan talaga kami. So sobrang dami ko natutunan kay LA.
Correct. And ewan ko, Kat or Ken, na browse through niyo yung Instagram ni Jai. Meron siyang post doon, no, yung si Chris Chu giving his friend, si T.Y. Tang, a laptop, di ba? So natatawa siya.
Yun, ano, best friends yung dalawa. Sobrang close talaga nung dalawang yun.
Correct.
Pero pag nasa court, syempre,
intense.
Tama.
Yun, tapos, of course, Jai, you went on sa high school. Diyan naman nagsisimula UAAP Juniors. Yeah. Anong year ka nag-UAAP? Second year high school ba?
Oh, second year high school. I was fortunate enough to make the team under kay Coach Jamike. So dami ko natutunan kay Coach Jamike ko. His style of coaching, yung style of play, I think yun yung talagang nagbigay sa akin ng platform eh. Dahil mabilis, sobrang bilis, pati hindi pa uso yung ano noon, small ball. Minsan lima kaming guards naglalaro and sobrang underdogs kami nung high school nung third year. Pero nanalo kami yung dilit namin. So yeah, I think si Coach Jamike isa sa mga nauna sa bagong style ng basketball, which was a faster pace, full court press, a lot of three-pointers, so it's really fun.
Correct. And around high school, naramdaman mo na ba yung ano, kasi I think your height is 5'7", was there any experience naramdaman mo na parang medyo alang, parang naramdaman mo maraming malaki talaga sa yung players?
Well, sa high school kasi I think the biggest difference as you go up the ranks, pagka basketball player ka, kunyari patanda, up the levels, is nagiging mas malaki at mas athletic yung players. So sa high school di siya masyadong problema eh, dahil yung size ko for a point guard medyo common, so mas madali. And nung college, doon ko talaga naramdaman, lalo na nung rookie ako, dahil yun, nabuta ko pa sila LA, sila TY, Joseph Yeo, tapos sa FEU si Jonas Villanueva. So ang lalaking guards talaga nitong mga to.
Tama.
Doon ko talaga naramdaman na I guess I missed it out.
Pero ito, correct me if I'm wrong, Jaya, pero alam sa pagkakatanda ko, nung juniors ka, parang majority of the time, shooting guard talaga yung position mo nun, di ba?
Yeah.
Tama ba?
Well, kasi dalawa kaming nakapasok ng team immediately nung second year high school kami, si Carlo Medina. So, parang kaming backcourt tandem nun eh. So, siya more of para siyang Steve Nash maglaro, Jason Kidd, na talagang assist Jason Williams, kung naalam niyo pa, White Chocolate, parang ganun siya maglaro. So, medyo ako naging sa scorer role ako, scoring guard role ako nun and sa three-point shooting. So, yeah, nung naging college ako, I had to adjust to set up the team more and be more of a facilitator. Pero at the same time, maintain the shooting from outside. So yun, during those times, I really wanted to get bigger, gain more weight. But I guess being being young, you're stubborn, and diba, you don't really pay attention. Major shortcuts yung gusto mo. So it didn't really work out for me na magpalaki because it takes consistency. So that was a teaching point for me. So it taught me a lot of things that eventually now in life nagagamit ko na rin.
Pero yun nga eh, na-mention mo eh. Pero how was that for you, yung transition from that? Na, aside from physically, na alam mo na you need to build up more muscles or gain more, yung mental approach mo from you know, transitioning your game. Kasi, syempre, in basketball, it's not always physical eh. You also have to use, to be strong mentally eh. And going, syempre, to a more competitive league na in college and going up against those big names. So how was that? How was your approach to that?
I guess correct me if I'm wrong. I think in physiology sa katawan natin, pag merong weak point, may nagko-compensate eh. Kaya may minsan sumasakit yung lower back mo, yung shoulder mo, dahil may weak point eh. So when I was transitioning to college, yung weak point ko talaga yung size ko, yung athletic ability ko. So ang nagko-compensate for that is yung diskarte sa laro, utakan, efficiency. So I don't know, thinking about it right now, naging advantage siya in such a way na grabe yung stress na napunta dun sa mental game ko na eventually nakakatulong siya sa akin ngayon eh, dahil some players naman opposite way na sobrang lakas nila, mala Zion Williamson, yung mga ganong tipo na, di ba? Yeah. Wala na masyadong isip-isip eh, dadunk ko na lang lahat ko eh, di ba?
Yeah.
Yun yung beauty sa sports eh. Lahat may kanya-kanya, you have your cards that you're dealt with, pero it doesn't mean you win or lose dun sa deck of cards mo. It's how you play the hand, so yeah, that's a lesson for sports.
Definitely. Ay, ta-mute ka dito.
Ta-mute ata si Dino eh.
Ito pala, comment pala ni Ian. Utakan, di ba? So, Jai Reyes, matalino maglaro. Yan.
Yeah. Yun nga eh. Yun yung nakita ko kasi.
Alam niyo lang bakit. Dahil no choice eh.
Yeah.
Diba? Yeah. Ka
at least, di ba, alam mo yung where do you want to focus more on? At least ikaw alam mo yun eh. So you had that that transition, that advantage eh. So
correct.
So parang naging survival of the fittest. Parang ayoko mamatay eh, ayoko mawala sa maglaro. So you're forced to adapt, kumbaga. Maghanap ka ng saan ka magfi-fit in. So kanya-kanya yan, kanya-kanya each player. Maintindihan nila yung journey na ganyan. Pinaka-importante is you don't quit and you learn from where you came from.
Yeah.
Yan. And just to follow up on that, parang was there, kasi ito kinomet nga ni Arsenic, no? 5'7", wow. Diba, umabot at the highest level. Was there a point in time na parang sinabi mo sa sarili mo, bakit kasi ganito lang yung height ko? Meron ka bang ganun moments?
Well, every single time na med ine-expose talaga yung weakness mo physically, you always ask that question eh, na parang unfair, ba't ganito? Pero lalawakan mo yung utak mo. Lahat tayo may kanya-kanyang challenge na ganun eh. Diba? Meron ibang tao na talagang gifted, pero meron pa rin challenges. So like what I said, it's about how you deal with that the disadvantage and actually think about it and then turn it into an advantage. So kung maliit ka, mas mabilis ka, you're more agile, 'di ba? Mas madali umikot sa defenders. Dapat you're supposed to pressure the ball. Kumbaga bring the game kung saan ka malakas. So in my case, I wanted to bring the game outside, pati yung medyo sa diskarte, mga pick and roll situation. So I love those situations na multiple options, and I don't have to depend on my athletic ability or lack thereof.
Yeah. Kasi I don't know if you agree with me, Jai, Kat, and Ken. This is yung height kasi is one of the major ano parang reasons why people don't parang bowlers don't go to the next level, di ba? I don't know if it's true for you guys, but this is one of the major reasons. I mean, exception si Jai kasi bihira lang yung umangat ng pro ng ganun yung height eh. Tama ba? I don't know if you guys agree.
Well, pero alam mo dati ano eh, parang we took pride in that eh. Kami, taonga namin, mga minions kami. Like si Anjo Karam, teammate ko rin sa Meralco, below 6 feet rin, si Logeric Fortuna, Evan Monfort. So, diba, parang, you know, respect to each other. Parang yun lang yung tingin namin sa isa't isa. Dahil alam namin eh, what it takes eh, to get there. Kasi, pero pinakamahirap talaga is the mental challenge. Dahil parang naiba ka eh. Kumbaga, diba, practice every day. Naiba ka eh. Ikaw lang yung maliit dun eh.
Parang, tama.
Kahit walang nagsasabi, nararamdaman mo na parang, oh, do I belong or something? So, each and every day, you have to prove that. You have to prove that you belong there.
Tama. Kasi pag mga big guys, nanlalaki yung mata eh, pag nakakita ng...
Oh, parang ikaw lang yung kausap na nakatingin sa'yo. May import. na walang height limit, so...
So if you were halos everyday you question bakit ganito yung height ko, bakit ganito lang ako kagaan, I'm not built big as a basketball player, parang what made you push through despite all of that? Kasi syempre it's mentally, it's ano eh, parang every time na natitake advantage yung height or yung ano mo, what made you push through despite all of that?
Well, a lot of things, and it's similar to all the challenges or obstacles that people face every day in life. Kailangan every day maghahanap ko eh ng iba't ibang ano motivations eh. So this day you might feel na I'm motivated, tatrabaho ko dahil marami nagsasabi and I don't belong here. The next day naman you find your motivation because you love the game, you enjoy the game. The next day you find the motivation dahil ito yung career ko, ito yung dito ako sumisweldo, ito yung nagpapaaral sa akin. So, ang dami talaga. So, your family is a reason also, your teammates. So, I think that's the key to moving on and not giving up. Dahil yung first part in anything you do, ano talaga yan, medyo stressful yan. Because you're getting used to what you're trying to do or adjusting to a higher level of competition. So that's the secret. You have to fight your way through and maghanap ka ng motivation wherever you can.
Right. What was your motivation, Jai?
For me, dahil ayoko mapahiya. That was napaka-simple pero being a young athlete, parang 'di ba? You have yun lang naman yung mga worry mo sa buhay dati. Ayoko lang mapaya sa game na to. Mapaya. So,
did you feel na you have to prove something?
Yes.
Like, or sa sarili mo? Like, aside from yung sa ibang tao, syempre sa sarili mo, like, di ba? Parang kailangan mo bang i-prove yun na for you to go out and compete. Did you ever feel that?
All the time. Dahil for me, mas motivation yung galing sa sarili. Dahil ikaw yun eh. Most of the time, what really matters is the yung laban mo with yourself. Dahil pagising mo pa lang sa umaga, kalaban mo na sarili mo eh.
Yeah,
so,
very
ulit, diba? Yes. Pa. So yun yung mas importanteng battles. Yan yung mga learnings ko throughout the years na alam mo yun, kung sana alam ko lang itong mga to nung bata pa ako, pero ganun talaga yung buhay.
Yeah. I think ano naman yan eh, it's part of the process of being better, yeah. Diba? Yeah, talagang athletes, everyone, kahit sino, you go through that phase na parang ayoko. Pero in the long run, you know, you know what matters. And yeah.
Yun. Correct. And of course, dito may nagpapa-shoutout. Mike Fernandez. No? Shoutout naman po to my
teammate
idol.
Teammate namin yan. High school teammate. High school. Mike Fernandez.
Wow.
Ngayon, successful professional na yan. So, what's up, Mike?
Wow.
Yun. Long time no see.
Ayan. And of course, on a less serious note, no, merong question yung teammate namin. GM question for Jai Reyes. Siyempre, you know, we were talking about before we went live, no, may fantasy basketball. May offer sa akin sa fantasy basketball si Ken. Van Fleet and Norman Powell ni Ken for Kyrie and Gary Trent. Anong comment mo dyan, Jai?
Ano mo? Ngayon nga pinag-usapan natin, fantasy basketball. Naglalaro na kami niyan since dial-up days pa lang ng internet. So pupunta kami ng computer shop sa Katipunan dati para lang maglaro ng fantasy basketball. Mga pag-set ng mga lineups and everything. So ngayon sobrang dami na naglalaro. Pero para sa akin sa trade na to,
sino
si Norman Powell at si Gary Trent. Parehong non-factor yan eh. Pwede mong i-drop yan. So, alisin na natin sa situation yung dalawang yan. So, nagmamatter dyan si Van Fleet for Kyrie. So,
yes.
For me, this season, kung fantasy-wise, Van Fleet ako. Dahil si Kyrie.
Wow!
Ang daming namimiss na games ni Kyrie. Pero sa numbers-wise, I think ano, medyo ano, even naman yan.
Ano kung si Curry ang pinapatrade sa akin? In-offer din sa akin yan eh. In-offer yan sa akin eh. Van Norman Powell for
Lugi
Curry.
Lugi na, lugi na yun.
Oo, oh, diba? Curry pa lang eh. Hindi ko, I won't give.
actually, may point na din si Jay eh, no? May point eh. Kasi si, I think Toronto is climbing up the standings. Medyo alanganin yung standings nila, but medyo nagko-cruise ang Brooklyn eh, di ba? They rest, ano? So, somewhat.
Hindi mo alam yung topak ni Kyrie.
Yeah!
Ang lalaro eh. Ngayon. Yeah. You need a break.
Ayun, kagatin mo na.
Mukhang ano, mukhang may mangyayaring
GM approved. GM approved yung trade. Oh, yan ha. From MPBL approved na siya.
Bata ko yun, si Van Fleet.
Oh, bata nga kasi.
yun, tama.
Yeah.
And of course, yan, isa sa mga boss ng boss pala ng Kings of the Court, no. Shout out to the FLOTG fam and Jai. You have one of the most iconic 3-point celebration sa UAAP. Yung parang shotgun kahit nasa Lasal ang palaging biktima. Baka pwede mong pag-usapan yung Jai, parang 'di ba? Bakit ganun yung celebration mo? Maybe pwede mo i-demonstrate or
actually medyo weird. Hindi ko talaga alam paano nangyari yun. So ano na talaga eh. Yung sobrang tuwa mo lang talaga sa moment na parang shotgun pero binalik mo sa bulsa mo. So hindi mo alam eh. I think first lumabas yung kalaban namin FEU eh. Na talagang those were one of the games crucial games na make or break for us. So, medyo nakashoot ako ng crucial. So sobrang tuwa.
Hindi pala planado yung celebration ano ni Jai. Pero sobrang ano eh.
Eh, no?
Oo eh. Yun yung ano talaga. Sample. Sample naman daw. Yun.
Oh, yun, oh.
Ayan. Nag-sample na si Jai, ha? Para sa iyo,
nag-sample na. Nag-sample na.
And of course, nag-high lang din yung teammate natin, no, from Dream Team. Yan. Hello Sir Jai. Siya yung gumawa ng artwork ni Jai dun sa event poster natin. Yan, yan.
Ganda ng mga artwork niyo pag ano, Bleacher Report.
Yun, thank you. Jai, just to let you know, this guy is just a college student. He's from Davao. So we just met him online lang. So Dave, okay. Galing. Yan, approve ka na ni Jai.
Wow. Galing.
Ayun, Jai. So, balikan natin yung rookie year mo sa ano, no? Kasi you've mentioned earlier yung transition, the adjustment. Nung rookie year mo, of course, you won rookie of the year. Pero, tough year for Ateneo kasi, yun nga, transition phase kayo. Not only for yourself, but as a team. Kasi, if I'm not mistaken, first go-round ni Coach Norman yan, eh, di ba? Sa Ateneo. Tapos, they lost key players like si Paolo Bugia, Larry Fonacher, Magnum Membrere. Kumbaga, ang ano sa atin yun was, wala na, one-man team kasi si LA Tenorio lang natira. And yun nga, pagpasok mo, you mentioned, yung you had to be, become a facilitator, ganyan, and backup to LA. So yun, parang just talk to us, like, yung struggles, yung, kumbaga yung mga naalala mo nun, kasi grabe, ito, Lasal, yan, masaya niya si Dino, sasikat, lakas eh, Joseph Yodes, tapos FEU, you had Arwin, Jonas Villanueva, di ba? So yun, like, for yourself and as a team, like, yung mga struggles nyo, like, gaano kabigat and how did it mold you to become who you are as a college player nun?
Well, that was the first year also of Coach Norman nung rookie ako. By the way, yung rookie of the year ko nung 2005, may asterisk yun. Dahil yun yung year na konti lang kaming first, yung totoong rookie.
Asterisk. Huli, no?
Oh, most of the rookies that year sila Axel Duruelo, Bonbon Custodio, Mark Borboran, puro ano mga super senior na one and done lang. So ano, doon nagawa yung kung i-Google mo ngayon, the Gyrates rule sa UAAP. So, doon nagsimula yung year na yon na pwede lang manalo ng rookie of the year yung totoong first year freshman sa college. So kami lang nila niyan, ni Dylan Ababu, James Martinez. So, ano lang, medyo may asterisk yung rookie of the year niyan. Pero kung tutusin yung mga rookie talaga na yun, so, ang gagaling sila Bonbon.
Grabe.
So, yun, that year, ang dami, ang taas ng talent level. Those were the years na Lasal versus FEU talaga eh. Tapos, yeah. We were kind of, you know, a Final Four team, third and fourth. Ganun kami, from the outside looking in, and we wanted to crack in. And it was the last year of LA, so gusto namin ni ma-maximize lahat yun. Pero ang pinakamabigat naman kasi talaga sa Ateneo at sa Lasal is yung pressure from the alumni. And I guess you could say that for UP right now. Dahil yeah. Some people, they don't understand the rebuilding years.
Yeah.
Yeah. They just want to keep on winning. They just win. Dahil, di ba, ganun naman talaga eh. If you're a fan, you're just enjoying it. Ayaw mo lang mapahiya pag Ateneo ako. And, you know, some of the people in Ateneo, they take it to the next level. Na talagang, it's their pride. So, that's one of the toughest parts because you would literally hear stuff na, alam mo, you're just a high school player. You don't really know what the UAAP, what the spotlight is all about. And I guess those years, dun medyo nagkakaroon ng pick up ulit ng UAAP the 2000s na medyo nauso na yung mga camera phones and everything. Right. So people were really watching again. Tapos nag-Ateneo Lasal pa madalas sa Final Four and finals. So that was the toughest adjustment, yung mga hindi na siya laro lang. It was, more people were involved, more people were invested in you. Without, and yung pinakamahirap dun is, you didn't know. For you, you're just playing. Diba? Just like, you know, correct. Yung bata. Gusto mo lang mag-enjoy talaga eh. Pero, when you come to think about it, ganun talaga eh. Pag tumataas yung level of play, tumataas yung competition, more right. Viewers, more eyes, so, businesses invest, mga ads, sponsors, so,
tama.
That was one of the toughest adjustments talaga.
Right. And speaking of which, syempre, you had a lot of battles, di ba? Sa UAAP. And yun nga, may involved na nga ng mga viewers. Meron ka bang mga experiences na hindi mo makalimutan na sinabi sa'yo na grabe? Baka, di naman tayo mag-ano, pero baka may mga ganun ka bang experiences?
Marami. And it happens to all of us. So, some players medyo mas favorite ng ibang alumni kasi usually ano yan eh talagang pag may player na hated from one big school talagang bandwagon effect eh iba nakikisakay na lang di naman nila naiintindihan eh so that's something tough for a player especially a young player na grabe naman kung makapagsalita kayo mumurahin ka, it's about your family. For the fans, it's just fun. For some of them, I know talagang they just can't handle their behavior and ganun talaga yung ugali nila. Pero yung joke namin dati is sa UAAP, lalong-lalo na sa Ateneo Lasal Games, doon namin nakikita yung totoong pagkatao ng isang tao. Dahil lahat ng tao mabait sa isa labas and everything. Pero pag naglalaro na, and ang daming experiences of VIPs, big-time politicians who would heckle you na below the belt talaga. Below the belt talaga na talagang yung family mo mapapatingin na tapos yun yung mahirap eh, na kasama na rin yung pamilya mo and everything. So,
correct.
It's bigger than yourself. So, yun, maraming experiences na ganun na, it's just not name names because they're still prominent today in politics.
Yeah.
But what stuff if it's from your own side? Supposedly, dapat sumusuporta, boosting the team, and then, yun mo pa maririnig. From the other side, it's understandable. Nakalaban yan eh. As a fan of the other side, you do everything to try to distract the player. And
correct.
Malaki yung spotlight, lumaki yung stage, lumaki yung opportunity mo dahil sa mga taong nanonood na yun. So, kailangan mo talaga. It comes with it.
Was there a time na you felt na or you wanted to retaliate? Dun sa mga heck.
Yun yung shotgun.
No, but I mean like, may mga sinagot ka ba, like, syempre, when yung mga talk, uso yun, yung mga talking trash talaga, di ba? Na habang pag kunyari, may nag-free throw or may timeout na sinagot mo.
Pero, Kat, I don't know, ha, pero based on observation ko kay Jai, ang bawi niya sa laro, eh.
Yung mga yun nga, eh. Pero,
yeah, I don't know if na-trash talk siya, pero, alam ko bawi niya sa court.
Curious ako if naisip ba niya, or was there a particular moment na syempre, hindi nakita on cam or syempre hindi. Diba? Mga ganun eh. Mga behind the scenes eh. Or kahit man lang you felt na parang sobra na to. Pamilya na yung... Eh, syempre, sabi mo nga na pag pamilya na usapan, iba na yun, diba? So have you...
Pag directed kasi sa akin, ako in-expect ko na eh, na wala kang magagawa. Hindi mo naman control yung taong yan kung anong sabihin eh. Pero yeah. I guess... For me, mas mahirap pag yung may teammate kang nagiging yun na nga, favorite ng alumni. Pag pinapasok pa lang, huwag nang gamitin yan, wala nang ginagawa yan. Eh, hindi kasi nila naiintindihan eh, yung laro eh, kung ano yung ano eh. Mahirap dyan, pati ka sa nila yung kapatid, di ba?
sila na yung buong bawi para sa'yo.
Yun.
So yun, mahirap pagkakakampi mo, sa kakampi mo ginagawa dahil, you worry for him eh. Pati kung meron kang teammate na down, walang energy, naapektuhan na yung laro, syempre, matatalo kayo, kasama ka rin.
Oo, so, kasi hindi mo control yung na-feel ng teammate mo or yung mentality niya eh. Kung ikaw, yeah. At least alam mo kung ano yung kailangan mong gawin eh. But
by the way, that was my sister.
Yeah. Mary.
Hello, Ari.
My family is very supportive to the point na they hate me and they bash me if I don't play well.
You play bad.
Yeah. So,
yun talaga yung biggest critic mo, no? Yung the people that are close to you.
Pero yung pinaka-importante kasi doon that, the end of the day, they mean well. So,
tama.
Tough love nga, di ba? Tough love yan.
Correct.
That's what you call tough love.
Eto, may nag-comment to si Anthony Perez, watching you, Jai Reyes.
Auntie's my cousin, so...
Yun!
Salamat, salamat kayo.
And of course, the host ng of the Bench Podcast, no? Idol Jai, nakapag-fistbump na ba kayo ni Abalanza? Love your 3x
beast. Alabanza yan. Si JR. Sobrang siya nung 3x3 experience na yun dahil yun na nga, yung tagal walang basketball tapos biglang meron 3-on-3. Kasi yung 3-on-3, intense talaga siya eh. Kung panoorin yung mga international, yung Europeans. Kaya, so it's such a rising version of the game, lalong-lalo na sa Europe. dahil intense. Yung action, walang tigil. The players would say it na, actually for me, mas nakakapagod yung 3-on-3 kaysa sa 5-on-5. So syempre, mas mataas yung tension level, mas magkakainitan yung ulo. Pati, alam naman natin eh, Pilipinas to eh. So, ganun din yung level of play.
No blood, no foul.
Nakasama pa the fact na lahat ng tao atat na atat maglaro dahil ilan months eh, walang laro eh.
Tama, nagbaboy.
Boom, sabay-sabay lahat ng factors na yun. Pero the funny thing was, magkakatabi kami ng kwarto sa bubble eh. So, sa tataas naman, all good dahil, you know, at the end of the day, when nakapag kumalma na yung mga tao, iintindihan mo na pare-parehas lang tayo nagtatrabaho. ganun talaga eh. So yeah, pero no bad blood between us and any of the teams. Well, I'm just speaking for myself.
yon, di natin alam, di ba? And of course, Dino Araulo, Tonino Gonzaga, idol ko po kayo, ni Jai.
That's my friend.
And idol talaga natin yung si Tonino dahil, you know, sobrang kondisyon. Kung tingnan mo, para siyang college player, high school player ngayon.
Yeah. So I just want to share yun si Dino Araulo. Kabarkada namin yan dito. Tapos halos lahat kasi sa barkada namin Lasallians. Talagang taga Lasal. Siya lang nag-iisang Atenista na pag Lasal Ateneo game, talagang inaasar namin yan na talagang one against 4-5 ganun talaga. So yeah. Sobrang competitive din namin sa isa't isa. Yan, sobrang big Atenista talaga.
Thank you, Dino.
Uy, kapangalan. Uy, dinosaur, parehas pala kami nito. Wait to be Dino. Clear, na-train ko si Jai and Tonino sa Playo Sports.
Sa ano ba to? So, yung sa fourth dati. Hintayin natin siya mag-reply.
I think,
Yan, yan. Yeah, and of course, ito, si Sep De La Rosa, idol Dynamite. Yan. Di natin makita yung mukha. Naka-social distancing. Ito, familiar. Naglaro to sa UAAP, di ba?
Masanda fan, oh.
Ice Reyes.
Siyempre, pinsan ko yan. Naglaro rin for Ateneo, under coach na Mike, San Beda. Of course, his dad is Chot. His brother is Josh Reyes. Yeah.
The coach, Josh Reyes. I think he recently got married, si Ice. I'm not so sure, pero...
Yes.
Yeah, tama. Congrats, Ice, on your wedding.
Congrats.
Ito, ano pala to? Reyes Affair pala yung episode na rin. The biggest Jai bashers.
Yeah.
Sabi na dapat, di ko nalang pinalam sa kanila.
Sige nga, ano yung mga sample na binabash nyo kay Jai? Like, para at least... makita lang natin. If you guys don't mind yan. Ito, sabi ni Tonino sa Acewood, Jai.
Libis.
Club 650.
And Adidas Sports Camp.
Yep. Yung ano, sila yung pinakaunang nagpasok ng plyometrics and yung kung ano yung training na sa States ginagawa sa US dati. So, Coach, masasabi ko lang, those days, high school days, yun ako yung pinakondisyon talaga. Dahil, because of you guys. So, that treadmill, nakondisyon talaga ako.
Yun. Nice. Ito pala yung sample. Grabe pala. Akala ko, harsh day sa parents ko.
Yung mobile legends rin kami mga magpipinsan. Siyempre, dami na yung magpipinsan. So, ano kami, 5-man kami. So, yun. Sa awa ng Diyos, parati kami talo. Pero si Ice yung ano, isa sa mga pinakamagaling sa amin.
Ano ba yan, Jai? Libreng-libre, di mo na siya. Grabe.
Jai, question. Pag binabash ka nila, do you retaliate or do you keep quiet lang? And receive the,
Eh, kung totoo naman, so wala ka na rin masasabi.
Tawanan mo na lang, no?
Oh,
bawi ka na lang sa, ano, bawi ka na lang, hintay ka ng magandang game mo.
Ah, so pag maganda game mo, ikaw naman yung sasambat sa nila, ganun.
Di, dun ka lang, quiet ka lang.
Silent, talagang silent killer eh. Marang, okay.
Quiet ka lang, hintayin mo sila.
Ngayon lang pa wala kakita ng shooter na hindi makashoot.
Grabe. No, I get that often.
Wow. But it happens, eh, di ba? I mean, as a player, you really can't, like, 100%, ano. But, yeah, it's tough kasi na meron, alam mo na kaya mong gawin, tapos biglang, bakit hindi siya na-shoot? Yeah.
Talaga.
And I think, Ken, before we actually go to the two championship years ni Jai, meron question dito, eh. Si ano about the 2006 yung nangyari noong 2006 ito.
Ay oo, grabe yan.
Ayan, may question from Ben Cuevas. Noong tanong ng fantasy kanina, paano mo nabantayan si Japs kuha ng UST? Parang what was like yung journey niyo noong 2006? Saka how was the heartbreak for 2006?
2006 the si JC and Tal Dog Kramer, Maki Escalona.
Yeah,
buzzer shooter
niya. Oh, finals yan eh. Pati yung UST Cinderella story talagang last minute sila nakapasok sa Final Four. If I remember correctly, dahil rin yun sa last regular season game na no bearing na for us. Parang pasok na kami sa top 2 pero sila, they needed that game. So, nanalo sila ng game winner. So nakapasok sila dahil natalo nila kami. And eventually, sila rin yung nakalaban namin sa finals at tinalo kami. So nanalo kami ng game 1, just the famous Doug Kramer shot.
Yeah.
Na dalawa yung sumama
sa second ni Chris.
Yeah. Oo, no, magandang inbound ni Maki.
Ganda ng play.
And then, game 2, nagkaroon ng bagyo. Hindi yun. Pero nagkaroon rin ng bagyo. Na-postpone yung game. Na-move for another week. So, natalo kami ng game 2. Then game 3, the overtime game na JC had the winning layup. Parang, kasi libreng layup talaga. Somehow, it lipped out. Hindi ko makakalimutan, kinikwento sa akin ni Dylan na Babu nung naging teammates kami sa Talk and Text. Sabi niya na, ano, that year daw, meron silang kakampi na nagka-freak accident. He passed away. So sinasabi ni Dylan na yun daw yun yung kakampi daw nila yung tumulong na blinak daw yung tira ni
parang ano ah.
Paangano.
I don't know if you're familiar with yung The Six Man na movie.
Oh, yeah.
Oo, parang ganun dala. Yeah, wow.
So yun, sobrang fair game. Cinderella story yung UST nung taon na yun. So, sakit nun. Sakit nun para sa amin dahil sila JC, Doug, and Maki. They're one of the greatest guys na makakampi mo, sobrang bait nila, and so they're really humble and down to earth. So yun yung masakit sa UAAP eh, na ano eh, yung nag-graduate, pero yun rin yung maganda sa kanya dahil may bagong players na pumapasok. Pero isipin mo, that was always my fear na to graduate na on that year hindi na nanalo. Pero going back sa tanong ni Bin about the Jap school, siya yung isa sa mga guards na dinidin yung ano eh, yung lack of physical ability ko, yung late ko kumbaga, dahil malakas yung jumps eh. Siya gusto niya umatake talaga eh. He wants to get into the paint and you know, score layups or dish to his teammates. So mismatch siya ko eh. So fortunately, nandun pa si Maki Escalona and sa second group ako na natatapat kay sa UST. O tama, 30 points si Maki nung game 3. So, grabe. Then he went to the PBA because dahil sabi namin dahil sa pinakita na niya nung finals na yun. So, sakit yung series na yun. But
Ken,
ano, yun yung foundation I think ng nangyari nung 2008 hanggang 2012.
Yeah. Kasi I think, Ken, if you can recall, yung nag-guest sa atin si Coach Sandy, sinabi niya yung 2006 was actually a great learning experience for dati niyo basketball program eh.
Yeah.
Parang we wouldn't have sabi niya parang we wouldn't have accomplished the 5-peat yung 2008 to 2012 kung hindi nangyari yung 2006. Maybe for you on a personal note, Jai, what did you learn from that experience? Kasi syempre you were favored eh, 'di ba? Tapos yung UST parang second round sila humataw eh. I think the first round they were
tama, tama.
Oo, second round sila humataw eh. I was a witness to that eh. Yeah, but what was your learning experience from that?
Sa ngayon na babalikan ko in my perspective right now na nagpapatakbo na ako ng team. And sinabi mo nga na sinabi ni Coach Sandy, that is a good experience for the program. Dahil nawala si Japet. From 2005 to 2006.
Nag-stage siya.
Japet, it would have been a different story.
Yeah.
Diba? So, ano lang, that's just my perspective. Pero, nung nawala si Japet, nagpunta na siya ng States noon, we were still able to make the finals. So, ano eh, malas na lang yun eh. Yun na lang yung nangyari nung 2006 na yun eh. Na, nag-peak yung UST at the right time. Yun talaga yun. And yung game 3 na yun, talagang ano na yun, 50-50 na yun eh. Yung game 3 na yun, both stars of both teams, sa amin, JC, Maki, Doug, A-game sa kanila, Dunsil, Evangelista,
Jervy,
Jervy Cruz, ano rin, talagang A-game rin. So, masaya yung experience na yun. That was one of the loudest crowds I've ever heard. And unfortunately, ano kami nun? Kami natalo nun.
Nalala ko, no, pinapatos namin Jane Ad noon eh, game 1, 2, 3. Pero saya-saya noon. But kahit heartbreaking, grabe. Kumbaga, Jojo Dunsil happen nung game 3, grabe.
Ay, oo, Jojo Dunsil pala yun.
Pati si Alan Evangelista, grabe rin that game.
Oo, oh, that's the starting 5, no? Grabe yun.
Ayun, tapos, of course, binanggit nga Jai ni Coach Andy, yun ka pa naging springboard niyo yun eh. Pero yun, for yourself, kasi yun, three years ka na nasa seniors, hindi ka pa nananalo ng championship. Parang, does it creep into you ba yun, nung time na yun na parang medyo malabo na? Or parang, how did you motivate yourself na pagdating nung fourth and nung fifth year mo, yun, naging successful na kayo? So yun, parang paano yung thought process mo nun?
Yun na nga, yung pinakatakot ko kasi talaga high school and college mag-graduate ng hindi champion yung year na yun on my graduation year. So, definitely nung high school nangyari yun. Tapos ito na, 3 years sa seniors, hindi na nanalo. Pero on that fourth year kasi yung unang championship namin noong 2008, wala rin sigurado nun eh dahil lakas rin ng Lasal nun, sila JV, sila Rico. Pero that year, we were able to get really good recruits. Pumasok na yung, the 5-peat guys, pumasok
Hello.
Na. Ryan, sila Ryan, Buenafe, Nico Salva, Justin Chua, si Man, Javier.
Wow! Yeah.
Yun na, yun eh.
Nakas talaga yun.
So, yun na, nun. Sabi nga ni Coach Sandy na natuto yung program. So, the school really made an effort to get the top talent from high school. And binuhat kami nung mga batang yun talaga eh. Kirk Long nandun na rin. Si Bako, Austria. So, then Eman Monfort nung 2009, dumating na rin. So, yeah, that was the...
Grabe, bigat talaga. Bigat ng...
Sakit nung 2006.
Bumabalik sa akin lahat.
Nagbunga nung 2008.
Okay lang, nakaisa naman tayo ng 7 bago sila ng 5-peat. Nakaisa naman.
Pero... Grabe talaga. Hearing those names, talagang nostalgic nga eh, no? Talagang nababalik ka dun sa time na, no? Tapos...
Pinaka nabubuisit ako kay Eric Salamat eh, kasi ang galing.
Oo, oh, ang galing.
Eric Salamat.
Oo, lefty siya, di ba? Lefty si...
Oo, di ba galing siya sa... Oh, I think off the bench pa siya nun eh. Dun ako nabubuisit
eh. Siya rin, oo, isa yan. Isa yan sa mga, grabe talaga, hindi ko nga rin makakalimutan.
Ganun, saludo ng saludo si Eric.
Ang galing nun, ni Dino Arroyo. Yung
sabi
memory
sa'yo,
niya, grabe.
Sabi sa'yo, matinista yan.
Sabi nga niya, I think talo USD by 30 to 40 nung round 1.
Pwede yan, laging present yan sa games ng basa Ateneo. Lagi yan nanonood. Sobrang active talaga yan. Sabi sa inyo.
Zion Later ba to?
Yung oh, Zion Later.
Zion Later. Yes. Oh, import yan yung mga early days ng mga imports. Eh. Nagsisimula pa lang. Pero like kami, nag-umpisa kami kay Zion. Tapos Kirk Long. And then yan na. Dumating na Sam Ekwe. And now we have Ange Kwame. And that was the start.
Yeah. Jai, I'm curious, Jai, kasi if I, you know, if I can recall, tagal na kasi noon, no? That's like, you know, more than a decade already. When I watch you play kasi, normally nabubuhay ka pag ano eh, pag the crunch time eh, or the clutch moments eh. You hit a lot of big shots, doon ka nag-emote yung mga shotgun, yung mga sigaw. Parang how do you handle that composure? Kasi a lot of players can't handle that. Parang how did you develop that kind of, ano, was it something that natutunan mo lang or was it instilled na sa'yo when you were still young to, you know, when the ball is passed to you during the time na you need to make a shot, kaya mo siyang i-make. Kasi big time, bakit? Kasi pag di mo ma-shoot, ikaw sisisihin. Pag, ano, pag
na-shoot mo, parang, may marinig ka sa pamilya mo.
Oo, may marinig ka sa pamilya mo. Pero when you make it, parang what gave you the confidence to take those shots and how did you compose yourself na ang ingay nung stadium during those moments?
When I stepped into the starting lineup, so si Coach Norman and Coach, nag-usap kami and sabi niya, kasi yun na nga, nung juniors ako, I was coming off a role na medyo scoring, di ko masyado iniisip to facilitate. Talagang scoring and shooting yung ginagawa ko. So when I had to adjust in college, kinausap ako ni Coach Norman and he told me na I need you to facilitate, I need you to get everybody involved. In particular, si Rabba Aluseni, dahil siya talagang weapon namin eh, sa loob nun. And si Chris Chu, kailangan rin namin ma-set up na, during those days. So sabi niya sa akin, I'll make you a deal. You give those guys the ball, you feed them, you make them happy for first three quarters. In the fourth quarter, when it's needed, sabi niya, I'll make you a deal. If you do that, I'm gonna run the place for you, sabi niya sa akin. So, syempre, may hirap na adjustment yun, pero ano eh, masarap na magkaroon ng tiwala na from your coach. And of course, si Coach Norman yun. Alam na alam niya yung ginagawa niya. One of the greatest coaches in Philippine basketball. So, natuwa ako doon. I really felt a sense of security na at least kay Coach, I got his trust. So, during those moments, yung pinakamalaking bagay doon is ready ako. Ready ako na baka nga mangyari yung mga yun because of what he told me. Pero during that moment na hindi mo na kasi talaga mararamdaman yan eh, na yung hindi mo na maiisip na daming tao, lahat. Naisip mo na lang, libre ako, kailangan kong mashoot tong tira na to. So, during those moments, of course, parati yan babalik kung ano eh, ano yung nakasanayan mo eh. So, you bank on your practice days na,
yeah.
Hindi mo ititira yun eh, kung hindi, wala kang confidence na
preparation.
Or kung hindi mo na nagawa dati. So I think that's the most important part is for you to be ready for those moments. You have to have prepared for that already. Kumbaga hindi yeah. yun yung dapat first time mong nakikita. Na kahit na hindi game situation na UAAP finals or Ateneo Lasal moment, you can simulate those things while you practice.
Yeah, preparation.
Yeah, importante yun eh, 'di ba? Kahit sabi mo na bench player or whoever, whatever your role is in the team, yeah, you really have to be, ano eh, always be ready for anything. Kasi anything can happen in a game eh, di ba? Like, sabi nga nila, bilog ang bola, di ba? So,
kaya given that, sabi mo, Kat, konting, you know, looking back, there are times when players, and I've done it when you always see the negative, na I'm not getting playing time, the coach right. is not running yes. place for me or right. hindi ako pasok sa sistema ni coach eh. That's one side na nagiging tendency ng players because of the stress of everyday na practice. And but the successful performers, the great ones, ang common na nakikita mo na kahit na yung same amount na stress yung they're taking on the same amount of stress, they react differently. Instead of seeing those things, they kind of see the positive na, well, at least I'm getting 30 seconds of playing time, better than none. If you're not playing, at least I'm in the lineup, di ba? So,
exactly.
when you, yun yung common, ano eh, yun yung common factor or common behavior ng mga umangat talaga na naging successful na. Because of those things, you kind of get a refresh na kahit na hindi ako nakalaro, pero may na-achieve ako eh, nasa lineup ako eh. So, I must be on the right track. So, konti siguro adjustment na lang na tingnan mo kung paano mo ma-achieve yung next goal mo. So, I think when you take on things in that sort of way, ano eh, madadala mo sa kahit anong aspect ng buhay mo. Kahit di ka na naglalaro, you're growing a business, you're taking care of a family. Right. It's not the same situation, but it's the same way of approaching things.
I think it's how you see it, like your perspective on things. Like, I mean, it's the small things, but those little things, yun yung magpapa ano sa'yo eh, magpapaangat din sa'yo eh. Parang hindi, you just don't see it right now, but eventually, in the long run, it really helps you to, you know, it molds you to be a better, not only as a player, but also as a person, diba? Sabi mo nga, hindi lang naman sa laro. But also personally, you know, you grow eh, di ba? So, yeah, that's important na yun yung na ipapakita mo na, syempre it's good that na to feel that you play, you get a playing time, but you really have to see things na yung mga negative, feeling mo negative, pero meron namang positive side dun eh. So, yeah, it's good na you said that, yeah.
Yan. Sabi nga ni Lauren De Los Santos, I really admire po your passion and determination on and off the court.
Yeah, iba talaga. Iba ang Jai Reyes.
Now speaking of, you know, in connection to what you said earlier, parang kasi when you were in high school, you were a star player. And then, nung college onwards na most of the time, you were basically a role player. Kasi meron kang teammates like L.A. Tenorio, and when you got to the PBA, nandiyan na yung mga stars, di ba? Parang going through that, paano mo na-embrace yun? Kasi I think for a lot of people, that's a struggle. Yung pag-star ka, then you move up, it's a difficult adjustment. Papasok dyan, wala akong laro, hindi ako makalaro, tapos walang playing time. Parang what based on your experience, parang what would be your advice for, you know, especially ngayon, pag bumalik na yung basketball, parang ano yung advice mo for those kind of players na di nakakalaro or di ako sinasabi na hindi siya pasok sa sistema, hindi siya nabibigyan ng play, hindi siya nabibigyan ng shot. What would your advice be for that, Jai?
I think the most important is for you to be aware of the situation na kung anong meron kay. Pero I'll be honest also, I went through those stages when I had to adjust to becoming a role player, na hindi nagagamit na player in the PBA. It's because really of what you put in also. You know, if you go back, you can't make excuses na dahil maliit ako, dahil mas gusto to ng coach, mas pasok siya sa sistema. Although those things are become factors. They're not the meat and potatoes. Kumbaga, napakalit na percentage lang siya, yung mga excuses na yun. So I think yun yung pinaka-importante is the awareness eh. And that's something na I only realized when, you know, after the PBA and after those years when I kind of, my performance kind of dipped and then I had to adjust. But I think pag kailangan mo mag-adjust, and it will happen sa lahat ng kahit na you think you're performing or training in the best way possible, there will still be moments na kailangan mo mag-adjust. It's a team sport. Isa lang yung bola. You will have to adjust whatever happens. And bukod sa lima lang yung pwede maglaro, 12 kayo sa team. So isipin mo na lang, put yourself in the shoes of your coaches. Na kung gaano kahirap rin yon to balance things out in the course of a game na time na merong time pressure. So just take the positive always out of the situation. First, be thankful that you're there, pero you also have to recognize kung ano ba yung pinapalusot ko lang at yung kailangan ko talagang harapin at i-improve.
Yeah, Jai, you mentioned yun nga, the jump to the PBA and being yung awareness sa sarili mo, no? Kasi gusto ko lang makuha yung thought process mo. Kasi yung sa PBA nga, hindi naman guaranteed yung minutes mo eh. Like, hindi ka naman highly touted going in. And I'm sure you took your studies seriously naman nung college. So, kumbaga, if you're gonna weigh, like, yung life after college, kumbaga, pwede ka maging professional eh. I mean, like, sa corporate, ganyan. Pero sinugal mo pa rin yung PBA. Like, gusto ko lang malaman, like, what made you decide to jump in sa PBA kahit ganun yung sitwasyon?
Nung medyo senior na kami ni Chris Chu, napag-usapan namin yun sa Ateneo na anong plano mo. Of course, ano, anxiety. Like, after, ang tagal mo na nandun ka sa ano, sa sistema na sa Ateneo ka, tapos maglalaro ka, yung samahan napaka-komportable na, and then pag-graduate ka, it's ano, kind of uncertain. Right. So parang si Chris, he always said na parang he will play until this age or this limitation, and ano, alam na niya eh. You know Chris was one of the best captains we ever had in ako, for me, in any team, dahil
wow,
everything he did, it was planned out or he thought about it. So alam mo yun, very very efficient, and you know, we all know Chris and what he's done with everything na pinasukan niya. He's successful in everything. So ako, naisip ko na parang ayoko lang magregret na hindi ko sinubukan. Pero you know, I'll be honest with myself, nafi-feel ko na yun eh, na parang nabe-behind na ako, na parang yung deficit sa liit ko and yung lack of athleticism, lumalaki na nung lumalaki. Si Chris,
as you go up.
Si Chris Ross na yung umaagaw sa'yo, hindi ka lang. and during that time, hindi ko alam eh. I thought it was, wala eh, genetic eh, ganun lang talaga eh. Pero, no, like right now, you kind of learn through the internet and the availability of information na you can do something about it, that you know, your genetics, you know, gives you something, pero it's up to you on how to use it. So like I said, I wish I knew what I know now, pero yun talaga yung pinakamahirap tanggapin, na nakikita mo na parang okay, parang ilang years na ako pwede sa PBA. So I tried the ABL also, pero ultimately the deciding factor for me was I didn't want to regret na okay, dumiretso ako into corporate or something else. Right. Tapos, yun, ngayon, 2021, babalikan ko yung 2009-2010. Sasabihin ko sa sarili ko, sana trinay ko yung PBA. Pero at least ngayon, ayun, I tried it, I somehow made it, I wasn't really, you know, I wasn't really that successful as I was when I was in Ateneo. Pero, it taught me so many things, and ultimately the opportunities that I have now, what I do right now, is because, you know, I did those things.
I think that's a perfect example. I always say, kasi na when people kasi are afraid of failing in doing things, they're very afraid of failure, but there's nothing wrong with trying. So even if you fail in trying something, it's a win for you still, because at least at the end of the day, you tried, diba?
So if you look at things that way, you'll always be on the right path. Exactly. Yung mahirap yung ano eh, yung fear, it's the idea, it's the fear of not being successful, of not being able to make it, that's actually holding people back more than actually subukan mo muna mag-fail. Hindi ka yeah. mamamatay eh. Not unless, diba? Naipagbarilan kayo yung ginawa mo.
Try lang makipagbarilan.
Yeah, okay. Oh, hindi naman.
For me, realizations right now, the fastest way to success is to fail and fail.
Yeah, right, because right. that's how you improve on things. That's how you learn from life.
I think Kat and Jai, the perfect example is ito yung podcast namin. I mean, I never would have thought that gagawin namin to ni Ken and ni Kat.
Yeah.
We just tried it out kasi nangyaring pandemic. Nakiuso lang kami. Sige, subukan nga natin. Pero sports tayo, di ba? But, yeah. you know, eight months after, who would have thought magigest namin Jai Reyes, di ba? From someone that we just watch on TV. Di ba? Parang it will lead to something more. And parang I just go back to what you said lang na mahirap eh. May regrets ka, sayang kung what if tinry namin, di ba? And now that we jumped into it, ang dami naming mistakes, ang dami naming learnings as well, ang dami naming failures, but na we get to connect with, you know, the cream of the crop of the sports community. And that's something na, you know, that something that I could only dream of na hindi ko maisip mangyayari sa lifetime ko. Pero nangyari siya eh, di ba? Yun eh, parang...
I think yun nga, yung failures eh, di ba? Parang kahit nagfi-fail ka, ibig sabihin, there's still room for improvement sa'yo.
Right.
I think that's yung approach mo on like whenever you fail into something, it's how you approach it to be good at it. Kasi there's still an opportunity, there's still a chance kasi nandiyan ka pa rin, di ba? At least sa huli, masasabi mo na, well, I tried and, you know, even if I can say na I failed, well, at least alam ko, wala akong regret sa huli. Gaya ng sinabi ni Jai. So, mas okay naman na ma-feel yun, di ba?
Eto, may tanong. Kuya Jai, kailan ka magbabalik sa PBA? May nagtanong.
Siguro, hindi na muna. Idol James Purpose.
Nakasimangot tuloy.
Nakasimangot sa profile picture.
Grabe, Ken.
Pero hello, thank you for that question. No? Siyempre, I think happy naman si Jai sa MPBL, which we will be talking about in a bit. Ayan, of course, teammate Noon. Mo. Idol boss ko yan.
So, yung pinag-usapan natin kanina about 3x3 na medyo mainit yan, kasalanan ni Gab yun.
Okay. At least na clear na natin yung air.
Feeling forward.
Hindi, at least na clear na natin, hindi ikaw, Jai. Si Gab yung
Hindi ako. Oh, hindi.
Yeah.
Hindi rin si Tonino. Hindi naman si Tonino.
Hindi rin si Tonino.
Si Gab.
Back up lang. Mo kay Tonino dun, ha? Nung kay Kayo na ba ito? Kay Pasaol? Gulat ako nun.
Oo, grabe, no?
Nagkalaglagan sa mga.
Ganda na sinabi ni Gab. Ganda na sinabi niya.
Feeling
and from Arsenic, no? If you've never tried, how will you ever know if there's any chance?
Yan, medyo naging philosophical na yung podcast din yun.
Ibang klase.
Ayun, Jai, before we go into yung MPBL nga, sa aking 3x3, pasadaan natin yung overseas stint mo. Kasi, yun na nga, laging MVP candidate ka pa pala as an Asian import. But, kasi ano yun eh, uncharted waters. Like, of course, si 30 doing it sa Japan. In your case, kayo ni Tonino, tinry nyo sa ASEAN Basketball League.
Yeah.
ABN. Ang kwento ni Tonino kasi, like, may si Joboy ni-recruit siya doon kasi pang part siya ng coaching staff. Ikaw naman, pang... Bakit mo tinry naman na pumunta sa ASEAN Basketball League? How's the experience like playing abroad during that time?
Well, during my second conference sa PBA, after no rookie season ko sa Power 8, the second conference, last minute, I was cut from the lineup. Na nilagay ako sa reserve. I was still under contract with the team, pero I was put on reserve. So sabi ng agent ko, try mo mag-ABL. So, of course, ang hirap at that time eh, because, you know, as a young athlete, as a young player, you think na you failed. You failed. I didn't make it eh. So, Pero the ABL was a good opportunity that I just found out when I was there already na, wow, na this is a big thing outside of the Philippines. Talagang, yeah. That's the only basketball for some of the countries like Singapore, Vietnam,
right.
Indonesia, that time, Malaysia, Thailand. So, ano talaga eh, it was the Basketball League of Southeast Asia. And kami yung mga naging parang pioneers na import talaga nila Leo Avenido and dami pang
Filipino. Si Leo Avenido din pala.
Oo, si Jason Castro na una sa Singapore Slingers nung naglalaro pa yung Singapore Slingers sa Australia. Sa NBL sila naglalaro nun. So, dun talaga lumukas yung laro ni Jason. So yun, ABL, it was a great experience. Outside, more than just basketball. Sa basketball, import ang kalaban mo every single night. American import. Kung hindi Filipino import, meron American import. Dahil mostly, ano eh, may tatlong American import. So, imposibleng hindi ka makakatapat sa American import. And being a Filipino import, a Southeast Asian import, there were times where you play 40 minutes. Talagang the whole game naglalaro.
Grabe.
Yeah, and grabe rin yung team ng San Miguel noon. Chris Banchero was there. Sina Asi Taulava. That was where Stanley Pringle started out on his route to the PBA. So,
I think Joshua Monson did it. I think Joshua Monson started sa ABM din.
Justin Melton also. Si Mo Tautua. So, it was a good league to have. So, ngayon, pandemic, medyo naputol. So, sana talaga more leagues like that na mag-appear. Dahil nakikita na natin yung trend ngayon eh. With the likes of sila 30 na interested talaga maglaro sa labas. So, ganun talaga eh. So, the talent grows. Pupunta yung talent sa mas malalaki at mas malalaking reach na leagues eh. And, you know, the NBA is at the top of that. But here in Asia, it's so exciting dahil nagsistart pa lang. Yung Japanese League, I think it's a really good model na gayahin natin sa Pilipinas. Nabuo nila na 40 teams almost in NBA-style setup. And,
wow.
You know, in Japan, basketball is not that big. It's the fourth or maybe
baseball
fifth.
Baseball talaga Japan eh.
Pakauna pa sumo wrestling eh. Sana mas popular eh. So yun, pero they were able to find a way na mapalaki yung basketball league nila in that way, 40 teams, city based, home and away. So, and the talent they're producing right now, dami sa NBA, Yuta Watanabe, Hachimura, and you know, the younger guys, you know, dati yung Japan na yan, always for sure tambak sa atin.
Sigurado, pero ngayon, iba na eh.
Pero ngayon, you know, it's gonna be a different story already. So, but you know our talents, you know, sila Kai and yung sana sila Jordan Clarkson makalaro for Gilas and diba lift na rin yung foreign rule, talagang napaka-exciting maging part ng FIBA Asia ngayon.
Ganda
Yeah, so yun nga Jai, after a stellar overseas career, of course nag PBA ka ulit, pero you eventually jumped in sa MPBL. So, yun, parang describe lang yung thought process. Why did you, yun, kumbaga, ano yung thought process mo? Bakit sumali ka? Tapos, ano yung kakaiba sa MPBL compared sa mga ibang liga na nasalihan mo?
After nung second stint ko sa PBA, I thought I was done playing already, that you know, business or go to work. Actually, I tried something corporate. Pero nakita ko yung MPBL eh. Tapos sabi ko, ang daming nanonood.
Oo nga eh, grabe.
Ang daming nanonood talaga live. Yun yung pinaka-difference niya sa PBA experience. Of course, iba pagka hinebra yung game.
Tama.
Pero ito may kasi every game talaga may dumadaan tao. Oh, people would say, libre kasi, mura yung tickets. Pero ano eh, pag nandun ka, na-experience mo yung MPBL, it's because dinadala yung laro ng mas malapit sa tao. And mas madali kumampi sa team na dun ka nakatira or dun ka pinanganak. So mas madali yung sense of attachment ng tao, like how it is in the NBA, nagkakaroon na talaga ng loyalty and ano eh, and rivalry. With Nueva Ecija, after we took over the team, I think I told this to you guys na during our games, we would make an effort, mga 8 to 10 buses from Nueva Ecija, nanonood, puno lahat yun.
Grabe.
Kahit sa new game namin, kahit sa South, talagang it's an experience already for them. And yung iba, hindi nga man lang nila kami kilala as individuals. Pero dahil taga Nueva Ecija sila, walang team na masusuportahan, they've been longing to belong to something. Na parang, di ba, you're a part of the team. Dahil Nueva Ecija itong team na to, we're playing for you guys. Yun yung naramdaman ko sa MPBL. That's why tingin ko napakalaki yung potential. And of course, it also helps na si Senator Manny Pacquiao ang founder ng MPBL. So, probably just the most popular sports icon in the Philippines. So,
most influential. Yeah.
Yeah. That's something parang different. And it really got me out of my seat na parang, try ko kaya ulit. Baka meron pa. And then, during that time, after yung second stint ko sa PBA, doon ako medyo nagkaroon ng interest na mag-research about, yun na nga, bakit, why are other countries or other people, ang laki ng performance gap? Anong ginagawa nila? Like yung US, the athletes in the US. Bakit malayo yung gap sa mga Asian or sa Philippines? Sa akin, bakit? Kasing size ko lang si yung mga ibang NBA players like Isaiah Thomas. And Nate Robinson, even Steph, kahit 6'3 si Steph, yung his build, you know, he's so lanky and he looks unathletic. But why are those guys able to perform at that high level? So doon ako na-interest talaga. So nung nakita ko MPBL, na-interest ako and gusto ko i-try yung mga natututunan ko, yung mga nababasa ko and everything. That really got me out of my seat na, sige nga, try natin yung MPBL. So I started with Laguna. And because during that time, I was living in Laguna for a brief period. So naglaro ako doon. And the rest is, you know, right now, I'm in Nueva Ecija and the MPBL is hopefully, you know, it's a sign of bigger things to come.
Yun.
Yeah, so actually, you have a unique role currently, no? Sa Nueva Ecija, Reyes Vanguards. So you're also an executive, no? So, yun lang. Like, can you share, like, yung past and current challenges na inaharap mo? Kasi juggling, being a player is one thing. Yun nga, yung stress, ang practice.
Oh, iba yun eh.
Juggling two roles altogether, I'm sure, sobrang hindi lang doble, tripling stress talaga yan. Kasi ang daming outside factors eh. Like, can you share with us lang? Like, yun, from your experience so far. Like, paano mo na ma-manage yung roles na yun despite the fact na ganun nga yung sitwasyon?
And how is it being a GM? Kasi that's a dream of mine eh. Eh maybe for a lot of people, parang gusto nila maging in. Di ba parang may sa states merong competition? Are you NBA GM, di ba? So parang I'm just curious, parang at least tell us about that, yung role mo ngayon. In addition to what Ken asked you.
So totoo lang ako, nung naglalaro ako, and parati mo isipin na sa player, ano yung future after pag di ko na kaya maglaro. And isip ko, magko-coach ba ako? So parang yung coaching start for me, dahil really takes, you know, coaching, the patience that you need, and you know, it's an everyday grind. So sabi ko, parang mas ano, mas preferred ko yung ano, maging team manager ganun. Parang mas okay yun. Parang mas okay yung route na yun for me. So, pero alam naman natin sa Philippine setting, it's not as, you know, not as big as the industry in the US where there are a lot of opportunities. So, yun yung gusto ko, pero I was also realistic na parang hirap niyan eh, dahil parang kung titingnan mo yung mga nagti-team manager or yung mga nag-head of sports ng PBA team, the owner of the team or whoever is the decision maker somehow needs to know that guy. Yeah. Trusted yun dapat eh. So you kind of have to go the either the corporate route na magtrabaho muna for that company. Yeah. Oo. So parang hirap, ang hirap mangyari sa Philippines. So nung nangyari to, parang ano eh, ang bilis nangyari lahat. Being our team owner, si Sir Bong Cuevas, he's also from Ateneo. And his wife is the mayor of Palayan City in Nueva, Ecija. So that's why Palayan City is our partner city for the MPBL.
Right.
It's, aside from, di ba, naglalaro ka, papakondisyon ka, tapos dinagdagan mo yung position na kailangan mo patakbuhin yung buong team. Like, buuin mo yung team from scratch. Sid from scratch. And time pressure nun dahil nag-take over kami in the middle of the season. So, bukod sa dalawa yung ginagawa mong trabaho, yung mahirap is there's a sense of ano eh, conflict of interest eh. Dahil
yeah, kasi yung player eh.
Diba? Ano, it's just maraming pwedeng masabi sa'yo, especially the other players.
Tama, so, tama.
Yun yung challenge ng role. But of course, given those challenges, meron rin ganun ka, malaking opportunity rin dahil, yun nga, I'm the only one doing this right now, playing and, you know, heading a team. The major advantage is that, kumbaga, sa corporate, nandun ako sa day-to-day operations eh. Nandun ako mismo sa harap. Kung ano yung ginagawa ng frontliners, or in our case, ng players. Ano eh, ginagawa ko yun eh. So, common sa team and front office setup na may sense na yung team yung ano nila yung feeling nila hindi naman kasi naiintindihan ng front office anong nangyari dito. Bakit sila nagdedesisyon ng ganyan yung hindi naman sila nagpupunta everyday sa practice pero syempre sa front office may goals rin na corporate yan, business yan, may kailangan ma-achieve na mileage ganyan. So Yun yung advantage na nakita ko na I was able to connect those two seamlessly dahil nandun ako eh. Nandun talaga ako.
Player ka talaga eh.
Naiintindihan ko eh kung ano yung nangyayari. So na-align ko yung goals ng front
management.
Office.
Yeah.
Nababalance ko.
Ng goals ng team. Oh. Dahil sometimes it can be different. It can be on different ends of the spectrum. So for me, that's the advantage. Pero like I said, marami rin talagang disadvantages.
Yeah.
But it's exciting. It's very exciting talaga. I'll be honest. I'm excited to take on this role with especially a very supportive owner. The vision that he has kind of aligns with me. That what we want is to expand the sports industry, the basketball industry in the Philippines.
Right.
By making a team na para sa tao talaga. Yung main product namin is not something na mabibili sa supermarket or anywhere. Our main product is the game. Yun talaga yun eh.
Yeah.
Yun para sa amin. At para
like,
sa
fans. Like a Miami Heat.
It's like a Miami Heat. It's like an LA Lakers, Golden State Warriors. So, maganda dahil priority yung basketball ngayon. Yun talaga yung na-feature namin.
But mo naisip like that would be your approach as sa ano Nueva Ecija.
Well, at the end of the day, pag player ka kasi iniisip mo yung laro lang yun, performance.
Right.
When you have a role in the front office, naiisip mo na ngayon is teka muna. Paano masusustain to mga players na to? Malaki na sweldo na ngayon. So, kailangan may pumasok na pera. So, okay. Ang common setup in the Philippines is corporate back, which is, you know, it's the easiest and it's the pinakam less risks, kumbaga. Dahil parati ka may budget eh. Nakasandal ka sa corporate, sa malaking brand or company. Pero at the same time, you're also at the mercy kung ano yung goals ng corporate. So, naisip namin na ganito dahil kung produkto namin basketball, mabibigay namin always kung ano yung gusto ng tao, ng fans, which is maging part nung team. To have a sense of belonging. Na
tama.
Part ako nyan eh. Part ako ng Rice Vanguards. The same way you would say, part ako ng team ko sa Lasal. Oh, part ako ng team ko sa Ateneo. Yun yung gusto namin na makuha na, na feeling, na connection yeah. with the crowd. And I think that's much, much more powerful than bilhin mo kami dahil meron kaming team. Sa amin baliktad eh. Meron kaming team para sa inyo. Tapos, you know, there are many ways to monetize a sports. So we just really wanted to make, to create a franchise
yeah.
through the MPBL that is priority the sport. So we can support grassroots talent. And we also believe that we have to make it for the fans. Kung ano yung gusto ng fans. Dahil yun yung mas sustainable for us. Right. Kaya namin mas sustainable na product yun for us as a business.
Yeah. Kasi kung walang manunood, wala rin. Di ba?
Oo. Oh. Oh.
Kailangan mo talaga maka-build ng ano talaga fan base before ano kasi yun nga eh, 'di ba?
Para naging commercial league ka kasi kung wala kang fans eh, it's like a normal league.
Oh, parang
oh, may quota lang tas kita-kita tas maglalaro na kayo for the championship. Pero iba yung may crowd eh.
Yeah. And kung isipin mo the biggest sports league kahit na tingnan mo lang sa NBA or
NFL.
NFL, yeah. Sa Europe, yung football.
EuroLeague. UAAP.
EuroLeague. Tapos dito naman, UAAP, PBA.
Mm-hmm.
Yung mga top leagues, kung nasan yung top talents. Dahil yun yung pinaka-entertaining panoorin. At the end of the day, kahit na gaano ka-analyst yung fan, kahit na gaano ka-about the game siya, X's and O's technical, at the base of it all, we're all enjoying it. We're all watching it. We're all playing it because we enjoy it. So, yung pinaka-enjoyable na level of play is yung pinaka-magagaling na players, of course.
Tama.
So, yan yung gusto namin na, yan yung always namin priority for our fans.
Ayan. Of course, from our teammate din, no? Si In The Zone. Ito si In The Zone PH, no? Nueva, si Christian John Cristobal. Nueva, Ecija, super solid ng fanbase. Naalala ko nun last MPBL All-Star half ng audience ata fans ng Nueva, Ecija.
Yeah. Totoo yan. Yung All-Star game ng MPBL, of course, kailangan ng malaking venue. Pero the downside is, hindi namin magawa sa province. So, ginagawa ni Senator Manny sa MOA Arena. And yun, siguro more than 10 buses traveled from Nueva Ecija until MOA. So ganun ka solid yung fans na natatap ng MPBL. And early on pa lang nakikita na namin that this way of bringing the sport basketball to the fans na team nyo lang kami, wala kayong kailangan bilhin para maging ano, maging part kayo ng brotherhood na to ng Nueva Ecija Rice Vanguards. Team nyo lang kami. So early on nakikita na namin voluntary ka lang sumakay dun sa bus for 6 hours, 8 hours. Alam na namin na you know, we're kind of getting across the fans.
Right.
Iba rin kasi no when you represent something tapos ganun yung support na ano na nakukuha mo. Parang it boosts talaga yung ano may talagang yung akala mo like you para sa'yo, you're just playing the sport that you love. You're just, you know, you're just there for the sport. But then, behind it, you know, it's really the people who support you. So
yeah, correct.
Diba? Oo, yeah.
Ito na, I'm not so sure if this is a relevant. I think pro league naman ang MPBL, di ba?
Officially amateur. But I'll give my honest opinion that there's no way to go but to eventually go pro. But you know, we must understand that 3 seasons pa lang MPBL.
Yeah.
And some people are talking about it na ang dami niyang kakulangan as if ang tagal na niyang nandiyan. But if you look at it
3 years.
Look at it in another way for 3 years.
Ang bilis ng growth.
You know, it's just a matter of keeping kung ano yung mga successful. And yun nga, ititinker mo kung ano yung mga kailangan pang i-improve. And I think eventually kailangan rin maging pro ng MPBL talaga.
Yep.
Ayun. So, guys, abangan nyo yung mga susunod pa na gagawin ni executive dynamite no sa MPBL kasi yun na nga bagamat pandemic ngayon exciting things are in store sa of course yung Nueva Ecija Rice Vanguards no grabe addition Juan Gomez de Liano isipin mo naman
kukuha tayo ng mga players talaga na the top talents that we can given the landscape of the MPBL right. Na dahil yun yung ano eh gusto namin ibigay sa mga nanonood sa amin, sa mga fans ng Rice Vanguards, na matuwa kayo, di ba? The Brooklyn Nets, kung titingnan mo yung Brooklyn Nets, nobody knows if they're gonna win the championship or not, but everybody's watching them.
Tama.
Diba? So now, when you get the attention of the people, it's now up to you what message you wanna convey to them, di ba? So I think, getting the top talent, the most exciting players, is the step in the right direction. It doesn't automatically mean you will win the championship, but it's going to be a big factor.
Tama. Tawag siguro sa iyo pag ano no, Boss Jay. Boss Jay. Pati sa practice mo, Boss.
Yung mahirap.
Hindi lang Jay, no, Boss Jay.
Yun talaga yung mahirap na challenges, but you know, we learn along the way. So and you know, at the end of the day,
balance yun, Jay.
Yun nga tatanungin ko eh.
Paano mo pina-balance, Jay? Kasi syempre
is there a certain limitation or like how do you
mahirap eh kasi sometimes diba, alam niyo naman eh
parang ko boss ko to eh hindi ko pwedeng agrabedo
when you play pag naglalaro ka alam mo minsan heated eh siya, tapos syempre sa level na ganun na ganyan nakataas hindi na lang siya part teams na careers na talaga yung nakasalalay and trabaho syempre minsan mainit yung usapan eh and tama. Pag player sa player normal, pero kung isipin mo, di ba, iba na yung dynamics, so medyo challenge dun. But at the end of the day, sinasabi ko na I'm always a player. Pag nandito sa court, player ako. Pero I also have to do my role.
As the
one running the franchise. So, yun na lang.
Being able to separate that.
Pati just use the advantages. Na yun na nga, ang seamless ng link eh, ng players to the front office eh. Kung meron kailangan kayo or anything, nandyan, nakikita ko. You guys can openly talk to me right away. Whereas sa ibang setup na ano, hirap, hindi masyado nakakausap yung ano, the ones calling the shots talaga. So, just wanna put the attention to the benefits of it and yung mga cons naman and yung mga challenges. I mean, there are other ways to deal with it. Dahil pag successful, mostly yung mga ano naman din naman na isang tabi most of the time when success is there, yung mga challenges, 'di ba? Medyo namumute ng konti.
Correct. Galing.
Ayun. Speaking of ano no, enjoying basketball, watching basketball. We were blessed last year, no? Kasi Chooks to go 3x3 happened during the pandemic. And very unique yung experience nyo, Jai. Kasi you tapped nga si Juan Gomez de Liano and the buzz was really high on him kasi yun na, he's Juan Gomez de Liano. But unfortunately, nung preliminary rounds, he suffered an ankle injury. Kakaibang experience talaga sa inyo eh. Parang share mo lang din. Like, yun, gaano kahirap. First of all, gaano kahirap itayo yung bubble, implement yung bubble. And secondly, like yung team experience nyo, na yun nga, given na na-injure si 1GDL, and yun, kumbaga, you still surpass expectations despite all of that eh.
The bubble, yung pag-organize ng bubble, of course, we give credit to the team of Chooks and the team of sila Coach Eric Altamirano for making it possible in such a short time. And of course, the teams, na they were there to support and they were ready to bring basketball back. Dahil, aminin natin, ang hirap to restart eh. Dahil walang certainties, there are added factors na sobrang serious such as the virus. So, it was a sacrifice for everybody. Dahil, di ba, hindi ka nakaka-uwi eh. nandun ka lang talaga eh. Although sa amin, mas mabilis than the PBA. You play multiple games every day. Tapos isang araw lang yung pahinga. So, that was a very big challenge. Dun kaya, dun mo nakita sino kondisyon eh. Lumabas si Zags kung gaano ko kondisyon siya.
Tama,
so,
that was
one of the biggest factors ng ganun na setup na bubble type. With one, sayang because we were supposed to have Javi also and their other brother, si Joe. So, yeah. It was supposed to be them, di ba? Pwede silang tatlo maglaro sabay-sabay. So ang saya sana nun. And to be able to play with the talent like Juan, obviously ngayon na sa Gilas pool na. And I think sky's the limit for him. He has everything, all the tools, yeah. And the mindset. At such a young age, nandun na yung mindset sa kanya na I know what to do. And I know that I have what it takes. So, it's gonna be fun. Hopefully, he stays with us for a longer period of time. Dahil, di ba? Ang sarap magkaroon ng ganun na
ang galing, player ano?
Team. Rising may, star talaga.
Di, may national team player ka na nasa MPBL naglalaro.
Yeah. So, oh,
that's different. Di ba? Normally, PBA or UAAP or NCAA, di ba? Hmm. Pero ito, MPBL. I think it's a breakthrough. Kung
mangyari. And, you know, nandyan sila Alain Bulanadi, tapos sila Ray Suerte, who played for Basilan and Batangas. Pero they were still nasa transition level kasi sila eh, from their NCAA and UAAP. They went to the MPBL para may malaroan. And then, na-select sila sa pool. With one, what's interesting is that he might be done playing in the UAAP already. But he still chose to play in the MPBL. So I think that's a big step in the right direction for not just us, but other teams in the whole league of the MPBL. Na, yan na, unti-unti na, oh, na kahit yung top talents, naglalaro na dito sa atin.
Yeah, yun. Correct.
Slowly building.
Sarap panoorin daw ng mga hoop junkie highlights nyo, idol. Anong highlights ba yan, Monchi? Yung bakbakan ba o yung basketball?
Ibang klase ng action nata yun.
Oh, shout out kay Hoop Junkie.
Junkie.
Nung nagkakilala kami, kaka-start lang yung nung page niya. Right now, he's one of the best pages.
I think
pages,
he's yeah.
Online, grabe. And it's opening up a lot of opportunities for him.
Yeah.
That I can say.
Yeah. Jay, ito last question na lang sa 3x3, no? Kasi napag-usapan namin ni Kat, like sa 3x3, parang there's nowhere to hide kasi. Parang
yun,
compared
tama.
To 5-on-5, no? Mm-hmm. Parang in your case, syempre, kumbaga, to be candid lang, ha? Parang kumbaga, syempre, may edad ka na rin. Tapos, of course, sabi, ikaw naman, aminado ka naman, you're not the most athletic. So, parang paano mo nakayanan yun na... Kasi ibang klase, kumbaga, one-on-one, di ba?
Marami pang handshake yun.
Oo. Kumbaga, physical yung laro.
Eh, hindi ka talaga pwedeng yung chill lang sa isang lugar.
Kumbaga, so, I guess yun. I'm saying na, kumbaga, yung typically, yung the player of your type, I would say arguably, hindi pasok sa MP, sa 3x3 setting eh. So, kumbaga, paano mo minodel yung laro mo? Paano ka nag-adjust?
How did you prepare for that kind of, that kind of game?
Alam ko na eh, na going in to a 3x3 event. Siyempre, papanoorin mo eh. So, makita mo sa Europe yung mga ibang events ng naunang season ng Chooks. Sobra grabe yung bakbakan. Kasi 3-on-3, there's no choice eh. You have to go one-on-one with somebody. Hindi ka pwede masyado umasa sa health. Defense,
tama,
double
tama.
Team, defense. Wala eh. There's too
ang
much.
Ang ganun.
You have to handle your own, both offensively and defensively.
Yeah.
So, nag-ready na talaga ako in terms of sa strength and conditioning na kailangan magpabigat ng konti, na a little bit on the strength side, and paano ko pa mas magagamit yung skills ko or yung strengths ko na dalhin nga yung laro dun sa kung saan ako mas komportable. Na and yung isa sa mga differences ng 3x3 is mas ano eh, mas may impact yung two ball or yung 3-point shot dahil sa scoring 1 and 2 eh. So, doble agad yun yung two ball.
Mas mabigat yung
so,
two ball.
So, 2 and 3, di ba? Mas maliit yung difference. So, dun ko talaga gusto kong dalhin yung
line. And, yun.
Nandiyan si Gab, nandiyan si Juan, nandiyan si Zags. You know, it will open up things for them. So, ganun talagang, you have to think of the game na, ano rin talaga eh, break it down logically. Para, mm-hmm. pagpunta mo dun, hindi ka, oops, anong gagawin ko? Alam mo na eh, kung saan mo more or less gusto eh. So, yun. It was a really fun experience. And I think na magiging malaki yung 3-on-3 dito sa Pilipinas.
In the years to come.
And yung Pilipinas eh. Ng mga Pinoy.
Yung mga video, no? Hindi ka na maka... Hindi na sila makashoot kasi puro physical yung sa may ano lang, street games.
Oo, pati mas madali siyang laruin dahil 3-on-3 lang eh. Half court lang yung kailangan mo yun. Tapos sobrang bilis ng pace. Sobrang exciting. Parang kang nanonood ng fourth quarter parati. So, I'm not gonna be surprised kung mas, you know, it gains traction slowly but surely dito sa Pilipinas.
Right.
Kasi, you know, if you're like a PBA team na tumitingin ka ng talent, ang gandang barometer ng 3-on-3.
Oh.
Ang gandang barometer, nakikita mo yung potential ng player. Yeah. Dahil, you know, he can handle his own. Pagdating sa 5-on-5, you know, I guess, mas madali yung transition.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Actually, dahil nga siguro dun, nag-set up na rin sila ng sariling 3x3, yung PBA, di ba? I think they're trying to, ano rin eh, emulate that. Saan, ito, ano na, to share lang, I'm sure si Kat, si Dino nakita rin to. Hindi lang basta sa Tris umano si Jay sa 3x3. Kumbaga, you saw the highlights, yung may bangga, may pulang. Yun na, abilip eh. Parang, isipin mo.
Which I don't think he was doing back in college, no?
Oh, sa ang isa pa napansin ko, Jay. Isa pa napansin ko, Jay, correct me if I'm wrong. Parang dun lumabas yung intensity mo eh. Kasi, nung college ka, parang more of nai-enjoy mo lang pang kuha, naka-shoot ka ng tres,
finish.
Yung signature ano mo, tas ngingitian mo lang yung ano. Dito, kumbaga, sumigaw ka talaga. I mean, you're enjoying it, but at the same time, lumalabas yung intensity mo dahil nga siguro sa nature of gameplay, di ba?
Yeah. Ganun eh, mas ganun yung environment ng 3x3, mas intense talaga. Dahil ang bilis ng laro, up to 21 lang yan eh. So, unahan talaga, sobrang unahan. And mas mabilis tumaas yung temperature levels ng ulo ng mga tao. Mas intense. Pero yun yan, yung sekreto dun is kung sino mas makakapag-control ng intensity na yun na mas magagamit niya para sa laro and hindi lang dun sa galit lang na useless. So, yun. Ano, sarap talaga ng 3x3 experience na yun. Kailangan mo ilabas yung side ng laro mo na ano eh, hindi mo na ipapakita dati. Dahil kailangan eh, no choice eh. You can't just stick to one thing. I mean, mas madali gawin yun sa 5-on-5 setup dahil nga liba kayo. Sa 3-on-3, syempre, mas marami kang kailangan gawin.
Oh, pagka-rebound mo, labas agad. Galaw agad eh. Talaga wala kang takas. Walang ano eh. Yes. Kaya,
yan, nag-evolve si Idol Jai nung sa 3x3.
Kahit na ano, matanda na. Nag-evolve.
Basketball vids from the tenement. Less ball, more bakbakan.
Yeah. That's why, sarap panoorin ng 3-on-3 bakbakan.
Mas lalo na yung 2 versus 3.
Umutang ko banggitin.
Ay, oo, parang naging dalawa na lang sila.
Lalo na lang samba yun eh. Yung 2 versus 3 na yun. So, na-foul out yung dalawa. Ano, just, kahit yata yung FIBA 3x3, nung pinost nila yun, ngayon lang yata sila nakakita. Sinang ganun.
Nangyari. Yeah. So, Ken?
So, yun nga guys. Ano ah, share ko lang, Kat, Dino, pag nag-3x3 tayo, baka easy-easyan yun lang ah. David, ayun, Jay, you know, on a parting, parting shots na lang, no? Kasi, syempre, lagpas na tayo sa oras. But, ayun, looking back in your career and as an athlete, as a professional, like, ano yung mga most valuable things na natutunan mo? and help you throughout your life. And in addition to that, ano yung mensahe mo sa mga tao na yun, gusto maging successful not just in basketball but in sports in general?
Especially for the small guys, Jai. Kasi syempre, pinost mo lang yung kay Van Fleet sa story mo. This is for all the small guys out there.
Oo nga eh.
Yeah. Well, for the small guys or the underdogs or basically the people who are told that you don't have what it takes, not just in basketball but in anywhere, that's just noise. I think that's the message that I want to tell everybody, that it's ultimately up to you what you want to tell yourself, and what you tell yourself is what you're gonna do. So yun yung simple message dun. And I hope sa Philippine landscape na mas maging tool yung basketball, na it becomes more pure in a sense sa game, because it's so easy to attach anything to the game. But I hope everybody remembers that at the end of the day, this is a game that we all love because we enjoy it, we have fun. So for everybody out there, I'm really encouraging sports, hindi lang basketball, kahit anong sport. Because it's the safest way for me. It's the safest way to learn about life. You know, it's somewhere that where you can make mistakes, learn about those mistakes, and not just what to do, but you know how to approach, you know, other types of challenges in life. So it's a very good avenue where it's always a metaphor for life. I remember Boss MVP always says that when he talks to us when I was in Ateneo, that sports is a metaphor for life. Siyempre, nung mga araw na yun, hindi natin alam yung ibig sabihin.
Nosebleed pa, nosebleed pa.
Oo, kaya pala naging Boss MVP si Boss MVP. It's because, you know, such profound things he can put into a couple of words. And, you know, napakalalim ng meaning. So now I understand more of that. So I hope people encourage, especially those who are struggling on you know what to do. I don't know where to divert my attention. Kung saan ko ilalagay yung time and energy ko. Try on sports. It doesn't mean that you need to be a professional athlete. It just might open up other things in your life. Other learnings na yun lang pala yung trigger for you to be successful in whatever you're trying to do. So I hope the sports industry here in the Philippines grows, and I hope more people support it. And to people like you guys, your channel, your page, please continue it, dahil ano eh, lahat tayo aggregators kumbaga sa sports and sa basketball.
Correct.
Ayun. So, Jai, thank you so much, no? Apologize na rin kami kasi nag-overtime tayo, napasap yung kwentuhan. But, you know, before we let you go, no? Of course, you wanna promote your business. So, ito.
Thank you. So, yan. Nakikita na natin yung power ng sports and yung media around it. Nakakapag-promote tayo ng mga bagay. So I hope people check out our business, ASTIG Roasters. We sell coffee, both retail and, you know, if you have coffee shops or you need coffee supply, you can contact us also. We're just about to ramp up our marketing. So we're making sure pa lang na yung distribution channels namin nakaset up na. So before we put more effort into marketing. So that's ASTIG Roasters, and you can find us. You're gonna be able to find us in Shopee, Lazada, Grab.
Yeah.
And yeah, Grab Food and Grab Kitchen. So yeah, I hope you guys find us there.
Jai, is this for daily consumers or more of for business to business?
Both. So that's why we're rolling out with Shopee, Lazada, and Grab Food, Grab Kitchen, because we want to be able to reach retail, yung everyday coffee drinkers, dahil marami na rin naghahanap. So yun, those are the ways where you're gonna be able to purchase our coffee in Shopee, Lazada, and Grab, and more. We're hopefully makapag-expand pa kami into more online avenues.
Yun. So yan guys, you can check out ASTIG Roasters on Facebook and Instagram. So available din sila sa Lazada, Shopee and Grab. Yeah.
Yes.
And of course,
in Jai, very short while maging available na kami, maglo-launch na kami those avenues.
Ayan. And also Jai, you have your, of course, you're pretty much active and vocal, especially nung 3x3 sa social media mo. And of course, on particularly on Instagram and Twitter, maybe you wanna invite people to, you know, engage with you and follow you on your Instagram account. Yeah.
Yeah, I hope you guys check me out sa Instagram and Twitter. Jai_Reyes. Well, sorry, got for the profile picture. So yun, you can ask me questions there and, you know, ask about the MPBL and my FIA. So I hope I get to talk to the fans of your podcast and your channel.
Yun. So guys, you can freely reach out to Jai on his social media accounts. I think yung sa Twitter, nag-e-express si Jai ng mga ano niya, feelings niya dun eh. I think may nakikita ako mga post eh. Oh, yung sa airport, nakita ko sa airport.
Doon naglalabas ng
mga tao.
Oo, oh, mga rants.
Therapeutic yung ganyan. And you know, it also helps to be active in bigger things that we're in, lahat tayo kasama eh. And lahat tayo apektado. So yeah. We have encouraged people to, you know,
yeah,
voice out what right, how they feel and mm-hmm. and learn mm-hmm. more about how they feel, because things change. Not all things are accurate. Not all things that we read, especially online, are true. But the most important thing is we participate dahil kasali tayong lahat.
Right.
Very true.
Yeah, and thank you, Jai. Of course, before we let you go, we want to say our thank yous as well, kaming tatlong hosts. But before that, ito, syempre, we want to go through certain people, no, that have tuned in with us since the start. Si Loren De Los Santos, thank you so much for your words of encouragement. Thank you for the love of the game. Thank you, Loren. Of course, from John Cheng, who's been... Si Loren, first time nanonood sa atin yan. Si John Cheng since episode 4. Thank you po, Sir Jai, for sharing your glorious backstory.
Glorious talaga. So, ano, maraming salamat. Sana ano, mas marami pang fans ang manood ng show ninyo.
Yeah.
Because napaka entertaining and ano, marami kayong mapupulot talaga.
Yeah. Eh, for sure, marami silang pupulot from the episode, especially from you, Jai. Yan. Kami, syempre, of course ako. And then yun, thank you, Jai, for sharing your story journey with us. My takeaway here is if you want something, you go get it. You don't mind yung mga noise or other negative things, kasi if you want something for yourself, you do it. You grab it and make it happen.
Yes. Napaka correct. Kung gusto, maraming paraan. Kung ayaw, maraming dahilan.
Yun.
Exactly.
So, Kati, send mo daw kay Jai yung picture ng kapatid mo. Para
sa kapatid. You be the judge.
Oo nga pala.
And of course, Arsenic, thank you, Sir Jai. With a heart.
Thank you rin for, ano, for tuning in and listening in. Alam ko, maraming ano, nagkakaroon ng sense of anxiety dahil nga hindi tayo masyado nakakalabas and things just happen so quickly out of the normal. So, for you guys who have shows like this that people can tune their attention to and, you know, make use of their time and may mapupulot pa sila, you know, thank you for making an effort for keeping everybody busy and happy.
Yeah. So guys, of course, Jai wants to connect with you as well. So if you're, ano pa kayo, I mean, kung may highlight kayo sa episode that you felt like it was impactful for you na sinabi ni Jai or nabanggit during the episode, why not share it on your IG stories or on Facebook, tapos tag nyo si Jai Reyes, no, sa Instagram or Facebook para makita din niya. And he gets to, if you have questions, you can also direct it to Jai on Instagram. Ayun, sabi nga ni Kathy, send ko mamaya kay Jai, he'll be the judge.
Sure.
Yan. Ken, maybe you wanna say your ano?
Of thanks course. Oh, Jai, thank you so much, no. Yun nga, apologies lang kasi
mag-aalaga pa siya ng bata.
Grabe. Nostalgic yung feeling, but apart from that, yun nga, I agree, like sports is a metaphor of life. Like ako personally, when we have kids, kumbaga hindi pwedeng mawala yung sports eh, kasi doon talaga matututo yung tao eh. Kumbaga ako myself, I've had numerous rejections, but I still love the sport for a good reason, di ba? And I think it resonates. I resonate with everything that you say. And yun, grabe, kumbaga, napapanood lang ita sa nung high school. Ewan ko, narinig mo yung pa-outside ka na, tumushoot ka ng tres, all of that. To, yun, being a family man now, kumbaga, yung cycle of ano, incredible talaga eh. So yun, kumbaga, thank you so much for saying yes sa pag-guest dito, and it's been an honor and a pleasure to have you here.
Thank you guys.
Kat?
Yeah, of course, given, you know, it's late na ngayon, but still, Jai is still with us here right now. Thank you so much for your time. Sobrang, I know time is very precious right now for everyone. So yeah, ako rin, di ko rin naman ma-imagine na, you know, one day I'd be talking to Jai in this situation. But really, it was really a privilege and an honor to be with you here tonight. Madami akong natutunan, and same with Ken, I resonate with a lot of your with your journey, with especially the noise that you hear from outside from others, but still you kept on going because that's what you love to do, just like me. There are a lot of doubters like me playing with just an arm, you know, sino makakaisip na kaya kong maglaro, but with you believe that you can do it. You see, alam mo yung kakayanan mo, and you know, I really admire you for that, na you just went with it and believed in yourself. So yeah, thank you so much for being with us tonight here.
Yeah. Thank you Kat.
Siyempre, Jai, thank you so much. Ayoko na rin naman patagalin, but truly an honor and a privilege to have you on our show. For the people that's watching us, never kami nagkita ni Jai in person, but he was willing to accommodate us and have him on the show. So, and for him to share his story. So, Jai, thank you so much. Maybe you wanna shout out people, or you wanna, you know, last message before we let you go?
Well, I just want to say hi to all the fans of your show. So maraming salamat for tuning in and, you know, giving your time. And sana magpatuloy kayo na manood ng show, dahil they feature the best out there in the industry, and the people that you can learn a lot from. So maraming salamat. Kat, you're an inspiration to all of us.
Thank you so much.
Not just, you know, choosing to play basketball, even, you know, first of all, you're a female, but second of all, you never let your
disability.
Never let the disability that other people say limit you, and in fact you turn that into something positive. And you know, that's something that a lot of people don't have, that the power na yung limitation na yun na sinasabi sa iyo, you turn it to something positive that only you can have because of your situation. And you know, that's how to go about every day in life.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it. Like, device even one coming from Jai Reyes.
No, ipopost na niya. Ipopost na niya yan.
Thank you, mama.
No,
but I really do appreciate that. Your words, especially coming from you. Yeah. Thank you so much. I just, you know, you just do it for the love of the game, you know. It's yeah.
Yung ganda ng plug mo dun, ha?
Diba?
Ayun. So Jai, thank you so much. I'm pretty sure this isn't the last time we're gonna interact with each other and connect. I'm pretty sure down the road we're gonna cross paths again, diba? Tas we're gonna constantly communicate. So thank you, Jai Reyes, for being here with us tonight. Thank you, Jai.
Thank you, guys. Thank you. Good night, guys. Good
night. Sali na sa Fantasy League next year yan.
Yan. Kaso kailangan 8K. Kailangan 8K yung... Kailangan 8K yung... Ano, grabe, no? Actually, di ko in-expect lalagpas tayo eh. Kasi syempre, planado natin hanggang 10. But...
No, you know what? I was kanina when ano pa lang, when we were briefing, I was expecting na maglalagpas tayo. But you know, it's basketball. How can you control yourself talking about basketball? So, di ba?
Grabe, yeah, grabe. Nagkaroon pa ng comment si Kat, oh. Grabe.
Oo nga, eh. No, but yun nga ano doon eh, parang sabi ko nga sa inyo, 'di ba? Like talking about basketball, you really since yun yung forte natin lahat, that's what we do. Alam natin lahat eh. So parang you really just can't contain your excitement talking about it because that's what you love. And 'di ba? When you love something, you love talking about it, 'di ba? So yeah.
Yeah. So yun na nga, given na si Jai shared his story, I'm sure yung mga viewers sobrang daming natutunan, sobrang nag-enjoy sa episode na to. And because of that, si Kat, meron lang onting kahilingan sa inyo, di ba, Kat?
Yeah, so guys, if you like this episode, please do share. madami rin ako natutunan sa episode natin with Jai. So, yeah. I hope everyone who tuned in with us tonight also learned a lot. And so please do like and share this episode on your page for our viewers. Please, yung mga hindi pa nag-subscribe or hindi pa nakakapag-follow sa atin, we are all on social media accounts on Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and it's at For the Love of the Game PH, and on Twitter it's FTLOTGPH. And yes, again, guys, we are now on Spotify, Anchor, and Apple Podcasts. So you can check our episodes there also, which we are currently still uploading yung mga past episodes. But yeah, if you have time, if medyo nasa labas kayo, traffic and then all, you can check our episodes out there. So yeah, and again, please do like and follow us on our social media accounts.
Ayun, tingnan nyo na may picture namin. Parang Clippers. Parang si Kawhi Leonard.
Galing na gumawa na ito, of course. John Cristobal, credits.
Parang ayoko ng Clippers. Ken, wag tayong Clippers.
Lakers.
Allergic ako sa Clippers. Ayoko nun.
Kumbaga, kayong dalawa, bili lang kay AD sa Lebron. Kumbaga ako si ano ko. Si
okay na ako kay Caruso.
Ay! Pareho pa tayo, no?
He's the GOAT, man.
Ayan. Learned a lot, no? Si Vansh. Thank you, Vansh. Of course, tuning in since episode 24. John Maverick Cheng, another well-spent Wednesday evening on FTLOTG. Great episode, guys. Captain Jai from Momo, Italia. Ayan. And first, grabe, totoo to, John, kasi grabe rin yung mga susunod. Ako, grabe yun, mga legends ng bawat school na nirepresent nila. Grabe yun. Especially yung next week. Daming nakaabang doon sa next week. Si Babes.
Ayun. So yun, guys, nakikita nyo naman, we're preparing very well for each and our episodes. Mayroon kaming posters, trailers, and hindi lang kaming tatlo ang gumagawa niyan. Of course, we have the whole team behind us. We call that the dream team. So I just want to shout out, of course, my two co-hosts, Dino and Kat. And of course, Neil Fernando, Jad Cristobal, Ben Cuevas, CJ Apale, Birch Montalvo, Kiefer Edionco, Kaiser Taylaran, Arnie Fuentes, and Christian Dave Marquez. And of course, Kathleen Disitinko, sila Ian Balete.
Sumusuport pa rin yan.
Si Ice Kua. So yun, guys, thank you so much. Hindi matatawaran talaga yung trabaho nyo dito. And I'm sure nag-i-enjoy kayo. At the same time, hindi madali yung ginagawa ninyo. And yun, for the viewers, especially the first-time viewers who are watching, yun, kumbaga talagang pinagtatrabahuhan nila para maging successful ang mga episode namin. So yun, maraming salamat. And tuloy-tuloy ko na, of course, shout-out na lang din of my fiance Naj Miravalle.
Asawa mo na.
Fiance na naman.
Asawa mo na.
Si Mrs. Ayan, busy si Mrs.
Hindi ka paglulutuan yan ng post meal mo.
May post podcast meal ko. Of course, siya yung responsible dito sa upuan ko, sa ring light ko, everything. Just to have a perfect setup here sa each and every episode ko. So, of course, plug ko na rin yung Better Days with Nats, yung YouTube channel niya. Please, if you wanna bring positivity to your lives, panoorin nyo yan. Saglit lang yan.
And of course, Newbies Broadcasting Academy, especially Sir Noel Zarate, Sir J. De La Cruz. Our avid viewers are Senix Alangsang, Gab Ferreras, John Maverick Cheng, si Carl Santos, si Vanj Clarin, and meron tayong mga bago sila. Yun,
Lorenz, Reyes si Lorenz, si Lorenz Santos.
Lorenz, yeah, Reyes Santos. Si Dino Aurelio, grabe, parang yeah. Encyclopedia ng Ateneo si history. Eunice din. No?
Si Priscilla din, of course. Priscilla, si Eunice. Si Eunice was started nung episode ni ano ni Chelsea, right. Episode 13. Yeah, grabe.
Of course, si Monchi from the Off the Bench
yeah,
podcast.
Off the Bench. Yeah.
Maraming salamat. Ayun, and of course, si Yanni Moya, Coach Rasuson, Coach Gina Katigbak, Sir Robert Sontan, and eto, hindi ko na babanggitin yung pangalan, si Guaps. Actually, siya yung nag-share sa PBA memes. Hindi ko na babanggitin kung anong totoong pangalan niya. Kaya dumami yung viewers natin. So, yung mga nanonood, hopefully nga, yun nga, marami kayo natutunan, nag-enjoy kayo sa episode na ito. Of course, my family, Black Five, especially si Monica, si Sam, si Miko Lagamya, and yeah. Si Nicole Yebra, nanonood all the way from Paracale, Daet, single pa rin. 28 episodes na, kagaya ng ni Dino.
Love month, malay mo. Love month.
Yun. Malay mo, makilala mo sa comment section, di ba? Yung the one for you, di ba? Interact lang kayo with us, guys. Kasi hindi ka madi-discover if you don't throw yourself out there, di ba? Kung mag-comment ka, at least you're showing yourself out there, di ba? Comment lang. Baka mahanap nyo na. And then of course, si Bin Cuevas, no, sa third episode pa ako, kay Jerby Cruz. So, kailan daw yung Jerby Cruz? Feb 17. Yan, momental. It's Feb 17, we're gonna have, you know, one of the legends ng UST basketball, Jerby Cruz.
Yeah. Ako naman, no, I just also want to give my shout out also, of course, to my parents and my friends. Actually, yung friends ko, especially yung Borlalu, grabe din yung support nila. Mo, kahit hindi sila, yung iba active sa chat, sa comments, yung iba na hindi makakapag-active, they really message me and, you know, they apologize. But, you know, I really do appreciate all your support. And I just want to shout out lang, please, I just want to congratulate my nephew na kinasal lang din last week, Justin and Kat, congratulations. And also to Jolo and Jan na kinasal din last week, and congratulations.
Congratulations.
So, yeah. And also, please, guys, I just want to say, yung sa Holy Fit, please, I did kasi an episode with Holy Fit. It's a series. So, please do follow Holy Fit in Instagram and check my episode there with them. I really enjoyed the interview with Jose Villablanca. So, yeah, please do check it out. And again, please follow me at the One or Mamba on Instagram and on Twitter. So, yeah.
You know. And of course, ako, I just want to thank my, you know, the whole team behind this, kasi sobrang intense. If you're part of the team, you know how challenging it is, or yung the amount of preparation that we do for every episode, you know, just to give justice for all the people that comes in dito sa show natin. So I just want to thank all those people, yung dream team, nabanggit naman na ni Ken. I just want to thank also my family, my friends, that's been supporting me, sharing our posts, di ba? Pinagtsatsagaan tayo since last year. I just want to honor and appreciate all of you, my teammates from SGV Basketball, Block 5, si Yanni, si Kem, thank you guys. My dad, my mom, my sister, my brother-in-law, pati yung kuya ko. So thank you guys for believing in me and for continuously supporting me. Sa lahat ng viewers tonight and the past viewers na natutuwa sa show natin, so thank you so much. Yun, thank you sa 215 viewers. Yun ata yung nice. Highest natin eh. I'm not so sure. Pero yun, first time, umabot tayo dun. At least we're breaking barriers. And of course, kay Monchi, yan, go step. Yeah. And of course, Ken, maybe Kat or Ken, you wanna talk about our next episode? Yan.
Yun na nga. Our next episode is on February 10. So, patuloy pa rin po ang Love Month. Basketball pa rin ang ating pag-uusapan. Well-represented ang mga eskwelahan. Kung itong episode na to from Ateneo, itong next episode natin from San Beda, one of the best to do it from that program. Abangan nyo yan. February 10, 8 p.m.
Hindi lang siya galing San Beda, aba, national team member na siya, represented the Philippines, at isang tanyag na PBA player ngayon, really raring to make his mark sa larangan ng basketball. So yan, again, February 10, 8 PM, sama-sama po tayo dyan.
Same time.
So guys, any last words before we go?
No, I just want to thank you to all. Thank you to all the viewers and to all those who shared. Sobrang saya na episode. And doing this with you guys, talagang sabi sa inyo, 'di ba? It's saya. Going to be a blast. Yeah. So yeah.
Ikaw, Dino.
I'm good na.
Yeah.
Ayan. So kung wala na eh, that does it for our episode for tonight. On behalf of the One Arm Mamba and the Dino Lee, ako po si Ken Pangilinan saying so long, stay safe, and see you next time on the next episode of For the Love of the Game. Good night, guys.
Thank you, guys. Thank you.
Thank you.
Always do it on my own, so I gotta get through it. And the only thing I know is to love what I'm doing. Never give up, never slow, till I finally prove it. Never listen to the no's, I just wanna keep moving. Keep my head up when I act, head up, that's a fact. Never looking back, I'ma keep myself on track. Keep my head up, staying strong, always moving on. Feel I don't belong, tell my thoughts to move along. Push myself to be the best, die with no regrets. Live with every breath, see my message start to spread. And I had so many dreams, when you hit your teens, life ain't really what it seems. Try to find out what it means. Always do it on my own, so I gotta get through it. And the only thing I know is to love what I'm doing. Never give up, never slow, till I finally prove it. Never listen to the no's, I just wanna keep moving. Yeah, I put out all this art, it's my only medicine. Yeah, everything I do, I'm just being genuine. Yeah, I'm sick of being screwed, feel my own adrenaline. Yeah, I do just what I do, and I hope you let me in. Let me in, yeah. Stable, oh yeah, no label, oh yeah. You know me, I have only a path. I'm lonely, but damn, I'm going hard. Okay. I want the real stuff, everybody listen up, cause I'll only say it once. I'm gonna show you all the path, if you want it bad. I'm gonna show you where it's at, yeah, how you can get it back. Yeah, cause I ain't never done, I'll be number one. Working hella hard until I get just what I want, yeah. Rises like the sun, yeah, fatal like a gun. Shooters gonna shoot and I'm gonna shoot until I fall, yeah. Always do it on my own, so I gotta get through it. And the only thing I know is to love what I'm doing. Never give up, never slow, till I finally prove it. Never listen to the no's, I just wanna keep moving. Yeah, I put out all this art, it's my only medicine. Yeah, everything I do, I'm just being genuine. Yeah, I'm sick of being screwed, feel my own adrenaline. Yeah, I do just what I do, and I hope you let me in, yeah. Stable, oh yeah, no label, oh yeah, you know me, I have only a path. I'm lonely, but damn, I'm going to win, yeah.